Welcome to the 5th annual One Vision 8th Grade All-Star Game, a CreaTV sports production. We are at Silver Creek High School in San Jose, California, and it's a crisp winter evening. Tonight, we have the best 8th graders from across the South Bay competing head-on with East teams versus West teams. I'm Mark Diamond, tonight here with Alejandro Flores.
Excited to be here, Mark, and excited to be back with the One Vision game. This has been a much-missed game in the community here.
All right, we're getting ready for the coin toss, and the home team is the West, which is in the white light-colored jersey, and the visitors are the West, and captains for the West are Perion Williams, Brandon Mann, Sinai Thomas, and Isi Tuugamalu Musu, and then captains for the East are Stefania Alante, Andrew Fazzino, Chase Cahoon, and Henry Allison.
Number 10, Stefania Alatini.
Number 18. Now, this is the biggest game this month, and I would say for many of these kids, you know, you may think the biggest game is going to be the Super Bowl, but tonight, clearly, for these kids and this family, this is not only the biggest game of the month, this is the biggest game of the year for these kids.
Yes, and they just got to make sure that they don't let the nerves get to them here. This is a game, in the end, it's just another football game for them. You know, they played this sport before, and they're also here for a reason.
Weather tonight, temperature is in the mid-50s with light wind from the west. And so this is really perfect winter football weather, very much like a fall evening, but we're in the winter.
Couldn't get any better than this.
That's right, that's right. Now, due to the pandemic, we have not seen this game in almost 3 years. They had to skip in 2020. They had to skip in 2021. It was really heartbreaking. 2020, they had to cancel the game literally days before because of the pandemic. And so both for the kids and the parents and everybody else, this is extremely special to be here tonight with these kids.
Oh, definitely. And, you know, it's a chance for the parents to watch their kids go up against the best of the best. And for the kids, it's a chance to go up against iron sharpens iron. It's a chance for them to compete with the best and to compete alongside the best as well.
Now, I've got to think that this is going to be the biggest stage for some of the kids. You know, we're going to expect, you know, some nervousness, some of that, and also some outstanding play, I would guess.
Definitely. Expect those first few plays to kind of get those nerves out. But I think once we start getting past those first few plays, everyone's going to start getting settled in, and then we're going to see why everyone's here.
All right, it looks like West has won the toss. East has won the toss. They've decided to defer to receive in the second half. West is going to be in the black, and so we've got ourselves a football game here tonight.
Can't wait.
Now, these kids have really legendary coaches. Legendary coach Jamar Julian and his East staff are going again. Now, the East has won this 4 times in a row. And so this, to some extent, is a challenge for the West. East has a undefeated record on this. Although every year we get a new group of kids, and so really it's anybody's game.
I was about to say that. It, you know, in the end, the past doesn't matter. Right now this is your all-star game that matters. You don't have to worry about anything in the past. These are completely different teams, completely different areas that many of these kids are coming from. This is a whole different game. We don't have to worry about what happened in the past, at least for the kids. And I believe they do have that same mentality.
Now, this game is great experience for these eighth graders. It gives them experience both what it's like to play in a bigger stage. It also gives them a taste of what's in store for them as they keep on.
Go on to high school level and go against bigger competition up there in the varsity level when you get up to high school.
All right, looks like we're about ready for the kickoff tonight.
Here we go.
Yeah, hold on. That's what we wanted to confirm. 12-minute quarters?
So we are at 12-minute quarters at this level. So we have 4 12-minute quarters, of course.
Hold on, dude. I had a question for you. That's why I was calling you. He just answered it. It's a 12-minute
quarter. So the returner for the West is number 31, Isi Tuugamalu. Kicker for the East is number 7, Matthew Pitt. Now, Alejandro, these kids have not played in a school together before, but they've had about a month of practice.
Yes, and sometimes that's all you need. When you have good coaching and you have kids that are motivated and want to work together, what sometimes only a month is all you need. And these are kids who are dedicated to the game of football. I expect nothing less but perfection.
Stand up for the kickoff.
A little short kick, onside kick. Picked up by recovered by Isaiah Pinnell, and he's going to recover that just almost midfield. And so they're going to spot that about on the 46-yard line. So West gets actually pretty good field position to start with. But there is a flag out there. We're going to see if that ball went far enough.
On the very first play. Let's take a look.
Looks like it's going to be a re-kick.
Yep. It's going to be a we have a replay on that. I'm guessing that ball did not go far enough.
And it looks like we're going to have ourselves a re-kick.
Great awareness, though, by the player right there to be ready for that ball.
Kicking team.
And that's going to set them back.
To redo it from the 40.
Yeah.
East kicking off to the west.
Not quite enough on that one.
Yeah.
So number seven, Matthew Pitt, is still the kicker. So Matthew's going to obviously get another crack at this.
Here we go again.
And 31, Isi Tugumasu. And yes, as we thought, they're going to move that back because of that penalty. That's going to cost them another 5 yards in distance.
So they will kick it now from the 35.
This is good for the East, though, because they have a chance to pin them back a little deeper now.
We had a really good entrance tonight. We had all the players had their names called. They went on the field. We had fireworks. A lot of pageantry associated with this event tonight. Okay, good kick. That's going to bounce about the 34. It's going to be picked up by number 20, Joseph Patterson.
Great tackle.
And he gets tackled by A.J. Rangel Jr. A.J. is out of pro sports training.
Definitely a player to look out for, too. 6'1", had the best vertical in the training camp as well as the best 40 time.
And A.J. was the number one pick, I understand, coming out of this. So we're gonna, I expect to see quite a bit of A.J. tonight. All right, that's going to bring up first and 10. Ball is going to be on the 37-yard line. I guess they spot that a little farther back instead of midfield. Brandon Mann, number 12, is the quarterback from Los Gatos Longhorns. And it looks like flag on the field. We're going to guess that's probably a false start, but we'll wait till they call it out.
Great play by Chase Gahoon right there. Just moving up a little bit, obviously not going offsides, but getting enough because he knows that there's a lot of nerves early in this game, and you can get players to jump like that.
Penalty on the offense. We'll back him up 5. It'll now be 1st and 15.
Just got to get those early nerves out the way.
All right, 1st and 15. Bit of high snap handoff to number 8, Diego Hernandez.
Tough running.
To number 8, Diego Hernandez, over the right side.
He gets tackled by 56, Nathaniel Buenuelos of Creek Wildcats.
That was a great cutback by Diego Hernandez there. The outside linebacker was able to cover the outside. One of the linemen missed their block, but he was able to cut right back inside and even fight for a couple extra yards after contact.
Okay, that's going to bring up about 2nd and 10 right now.
Made up the yards that they lost right there.
We'll call that a gain of 5.
Ball
second and 10.
Spotted on the 36-yard line. Hand off to Ikea McLemore, and we have a good run. He gets tackled by
great
number 34.
Taking over the right side, coming back inside.
Correction, that was Diego Hernandez who did the
great
run.
Great steal block by Hector Cabrera.
Ryan Pupak got the tackle for the East on that.
Yes, great steal block by Hector Cabantes there. helped sealed off the linebackers, so then he was able to have that great cutback lane. And then, of course, again, tough running right there at the end of the play.
Ryan Pupak, also part from the Los Gatos Longhorns. First and 10 for the West. Handoff again to Ikea McLemore.
This time a short gain of a couple. Looks
a correction, like Diego Hernandez, Chase, and he was tackled by number 66, Antonio Villegas.
Yes.
Antonio's also from the Los Gatos Longhorns. The Longhorns are getting a lot of action to begin with today.
And a great play for him staying disciplined there, making sure he wouldn't have that cutback lane. He stayed his ground, make sure he was there and ready to make the play.
That's going to put the ball at midfield, second and about 8.
Still waiting for the first pass of the game.
Do you expect a lot of throwing tonight? Do you expect more running?
I do expect a lot of running, but I definitely expect them to settle in with the run game, but be ready for that play action, especially later in the game. Here's the first pass.
Speaking of which.
Good throw.
The completion.
First pass of the game.
That was caught by number 17, Sinai Thomas of the Menlo Atholton Vikings.
Great one-step drop. Saw that it was cover 3, which means the flats have a very good chance of being open right there. Quick and decisive.
Tackled by number 7, Matthew Pitt.
Tackle was by number 7, Matthew Pitt.
Matthew Pitt is from Benicia Youth Football.
Yeah, solid three-step drop and a nice quick throw to the outside.
So this is going to bring about 3rd and 6 right now.
Yes. I see them possibly staying disciplined here with the run. Good play action.
Short catch by number 17, Sinai Thomas, and Jessa Deanna from the Milpitas Knights on the tackle on that for the East.
First down.
Great play by Thomas there. The corner had a chance to tackle him, and he squared his hips, but great play by Thomas, but being decisive, going straight to the outside, not trying to be too cute, trying to go inside, outside. He just shot straight for the outside.
You see here in the replay, just some really good.
Great play action as well. Make sure that
nice throw out there.
Yes, 2 great throws so far.
And then a good stop. Okay, that's going to bring up another 1st and 10. For the West. Diego Hernandez, the ball carrier on that, and he was brought down by number 33, Landon Weichel, as well as he had a little assistance from Stefania Alante from the West Coast Islanders.
Diego Hernandez right now is running very hard off of the line, and I like that because that starts to wear and tear defense, but also a great tackle there at the end of the play. Great combine tackle.
You know, really good start here for the West.
Yes.
I mean, they're making their way down the field. We really haven't seen any miscues yet, as you may expect. And just a reminder, we are not watching high schoolers here. We are watching 8th graders. These are some really talented kids.
It could be hard to tell the difference, though, with how well they're playing.
Brandon Mann decided to run with that. And he gets tackled by number 20, Chase Cahoon. But there is a little bit of flag down there.
It was in the backfield.
Chase good decisive from the Los Gatos Longhorns.
A great tackle
back the West up.
Okay, what do we got for a penalty? Let's see. It's going to be holding, and that's going to go against the West. And so we're going to have to go. They're going to go back a little bit. That's going to bring up 1st and 20 now.
Cahoon did a good job there, just kind of spying the quarterback, not following his eyes, but sticking with where the quarterback was at there so he can make a play in case he ran.
And actually,
Brandon Mann right there was also a great play with going through his progression. Saw 1 wasn't there, saw 2 wasn't there, cut back to the other side of the field, saw wasn't there, and just took off and ran.
All right, sorry about that.
It's all good.
Actually, more than 1st and 10. We're going to be about 1st and 25 because they're going to put that all the way back in the 44.
Oh, yeah.
So we got a lot of work in front of the West now.
Don't try to make it all in one play.
Long throw.
Oh.
And we'll see.
We're going to call that
Mann unleashes one downfield on the sideline.
Sonai Thomas with the catch, but unfortunately he was a little bit out of bounds on that, so that's going to be an incomplete. That's going to bring up a second and about 25.
I like taking that risk, though, because you want to take that matchup. See, it's first down. You know you still have two more downs to play with there. Also, a good catch by Sonai Thomas. No, he didn't get his feet in bounds, but it was still a great adjustment to the ball.
You know, I'm just pleased to see how well these kids are playing together. They've only been practicing for a month, but we're all already seeing some really good playmaking and really good teamwork.
Of course, when you have kids who practice together who are dedicated, that month of practice can feel like a whole entire year.
Ooh. Oh, that was intended.
Short pass.
For Kelly couldn't quite hold on to that, so that's going to bring an incomplete, and we're going to now be third and long.
Great positioning, though, by Landon Weckel right there, number 33. He was right there in position to make the tackle should he have caught it.
Now, you may notice, if you're a longtime fan of this series, you may notice on the sidelines tonight we have some alumni from the previous games, and we're having some kids that are in high school football. We'll talk about this a little bit. We have a number of them are actually starting in college, and some in some really, really good schools. So it talks about how this game builds connections.
Oh, definitely. It builds up great energy around the community.
Third down.
Good play call.
Screen pass intended for
EK
McLemore, but he gets tackled by Joseph Patterson, but there's a flag down.
Was a quick flag, too.
Yeah, Wes has got to watch some of these penalties out there.
Yeah, really great drive, just kind of hurt by penalties there at the end.
Again, I'm going to think, well, Hunter, a lot of that's just probably just nervousness.
Just nervousness, yes, exactly. Just kind of getting settled into the game. Remember, this is still the first drive. Definitely expect that to be shored up there by the end. Let's see what the call is.
It's going to be holding. Yeah, and that's going to send him farther back. Fourth down, so they're going to decline that.
Yes. Now, I know it was a holding call, and it wasn't that big of a progressive play, but I got to say the effort that I'm seeing right now from Diego Hernandez is great right now. He's shedding many of those first few tackles. I would actually don't be surprised if later on in this game, as things start getting a little more intense, he might be able to break one.
So the West is in fourth down territory here, so they're going to go for it.
Why not? He's got time.
Ooh. Intended. For Arian Meyer, but that was a fantastic block.
Yes. Number 52
by white tackle. Number 55. Ezeal Jessup to Yanya.
41 yard line on the left hash. First and 10.
Now, I understand going for it on fourth down. Obviously, maybe they don't know if they have a good kicker or a punter that they feel like they want to go with. Next time on that play, I would definitely try to take a shot, though. Definitely not over the middle of the field.
So, again, the Easter and White are going to take over on downs. They're going to be on their own 41 yard line, first and 10.
This is more of a power offense, more of a balanced under center offense.
Number 18, Andrew Franzino, is starting quarterback here for the East. Here we go. The heart of football is really not the NFL, in my opinion. It's not in the college teams. It's not in high school varsity, even the junior varsity. I believe that the heart of football is with these eighth graders tonight, because it's here they learn all the fundamentals, teamwork, how to do your assignment, hard work, diversity.
Oh, yes. Couldn't have said it any better myself. And they also discover more about their love for the game as well, definitely at this age.
And we had a little trouble there on the snap.
A little trouble on the snap there. And number 31 for the West tackled. EC Tugumusu.
Yeah, and a great play by him there.
And EC is from the San Jose Hit Squad. We have a number of San Jose Hit Squad players out here tonight. Really good representation all the way across the South Bay.
Yeah. And you think definitely having some players from that Hit Squad can definitely help out with the team's chemistry as well.
So the East lost about a yard in that second and 11. Handoff.
Nice run.
Dekea McLemore. And he gets tackled by number one, Perrion Williams.
Great outside run, but also a great seal by number 97, Daniel Simpson. Right there, he was able to give him the outside seal that allowed McLemore to take it to the outside.
Perrion Williams is from the South Valley Grizzlies.
Looks like it's going to be just a little short. It's going to be third and one.
And a little chip there by number nine. Angelos Gonzalez also helped out on that chip right there that allowed him to get the outside run.
Good that he had the awareness of where the line of gain was.
Yes.
He wasn't able to quite make it, but you could see him try and dive for that.
Oh, yeah.
That's going to bring up third and one right now.
Going out of shotgun here, too.
Handoff, again to number eight, Ikea McLemore, and he gets tackled by Denham Powell.
Great blocking by the entire offensive line there. It was just a great trap play, allowed him to just have a wide open gap in the inside, not only gaining 1 yard that they needed, but many more as well.
You see that come up again. You can see that Denham really sensed that and was able to bring him down fairly quickly.
And the great part about it, too, is he was able to just shoot right through the gap.
Nope. Denham's from the East Palo Alto Mastodons. First and 10, East.
Looks like a little change of the play here on the line. Press corner on the left side. Watch out for that.
Oh, we have a pick.
First pass.
Interception by number 31. Izzy Tulo, EC Tugumusu, all the way down to the end zone for the first touchdown of the game.
Heard his name a lot
by the
already.
West.
West, EC Tulo.
What a play. He was able to read the quarterback's eyes. He was playing from the middle linebacker spot. Saw the quarterback's eyes going to the left, and he just kind of shifted right into that zone. It was a little slant route, and he was able to just cut right in front of it. Perfect play.
So with that, West is the first to get on the scoreboard with that touchdown.
Also, great vertical there as he had to jump up to catch the ball, and also not to mention the great return that he had there, breaking that tackle right there at the end to make sure he got into the end zone.
Not only got the pick, but also was able to really make his way all the way down the field, break those tackles, as you say.
A little cherry.
Really, really good effort.
West has a 6-0 lead. The point after touchdown is next.
That's what you like to see out of a linebacker, though. Reading the quarterback's eyes, being able to fill the gap, find out where he thinks the quarterback is going to throw the ball.
So they have the offense on the field, so we think they're going to probably go for two.
I imagine we'll be seeing a lot of going for fourth downs and going for twos with this team.
Oh, what a read! We have an interception.
And it looks like, okay, it looks like you can't return it for the team.
And you can't, in this league, you can't return it. But that's still a good stop.
We were just talking about
East against that. So 5 minutes and 55 seconds left in this first quarter. West takes a 6-0 lead over the perennial rivals, the East.
Now, it didn't look like it was a full man coverage because he did have his eyes on the quarterback, but we just talked about it with the linebacker position, reading the quarterback's eyes, and obviously with the rollout, he knew it was going to the left side. Great play, also noticing the route of the slot receiver, and he was able to make a great play cutting the route, and he probably could have returned it almost if it was still allowed.
You know, the One Vision mission is to help individuals achieve their personal and physical goals as a student, recreational, and as a professional athlete. The motto of One Vision is leave your mark.
Yeah.
This program is just really a lot more than just football.
No, and that's what I love about it. You know, they have visitors, people who come in, talk to them not only about football itself, but about education, the NCAA, everything about it, you know, how to adjust to the high school life and beyond.
Let's stand up for the kickoff, everybody. Let's go, everybody. Stand up for the kickoff.
Now, that's a great play, though, by the East team right there. It's a good momentum play. Now, you just had a play. Now, you just had a great play there where you kind of get that energy back up. I know it was a pick six. You know, you just got to shake it off, and that helps a lot.
So the East is obviously going to receive, and Stefania, number 10, and Chase Cahoon are in the backfield for the return on that. Kicking for the West is number 31.
Now, we already saw one onside attempt. Do we see another
Tolo
one here?
Tugumusu, and we've seen a lot of EC tonight, and I expect we'll continue to see a lot of him.
Definitely.
Good kick.
Very good kick.
Get scooped up by number 20, Chase Cahoon. And Chase is able to get out to about the 30-yard line. He was tackled, by the way, by number 32, Caden Kelly, also of the Los Gatos Longhorns.
Great tackle. Way to get there. It was also a great kick because it had a couple bounces that made Cahoon have to kind of wait there and make sure he secured it, which gave the kicking team a chance to get down there and make that tackle. Now, the biggest thing here is coming out off of an interception. I want to make sure the quarterback, you got to shake that off. And I also think for the offense, you don't go away from the pass. You know, definitely trust your quarterback. That's one play. We shake it off. I expect to see a great bounce back here from this quarterback.
You know, it's really important. One of the things kids are learning is the importance of a short-term memory.
Definitely. And especially at the quarterback position.
Andrew Franzino, the quarterback, and he hands off to number 8, E.K. McLemore, and he gets tackled by number 58, Nico Quintana from the Milpitas Knights, and also Santino Berrigan, Morgan Hill Raiders.
And also from the safety right there, Kamani. Great play just overall. Good first initial hit, and then to finish it off from the rest of the team.
Yeah, I'm really impressed how, these eighth graders are reading the plays out
yes,
there.
Yes, definitely.
I mean, they are, this is not catch and run football. This is two sides strategically competing against each other.
Playing as a strong collective unit right now. It's great to see.
Okay, second and 8. The East is going to hand off the ball to number 8. E.K. McLemore, and he gets tackled by number 31. He's a Tugumusu.
Tugumusu, we're already hearing his name a lot right now. I like the idea of staying disciplined with the run, though.
That's going to be good for about 3 yards, and that's going to bring up 3rd and 4.
Yeah, strong run there by Elijah McLemore, being able to break that first tackle to gain a couple extra yards, making it 3rd and manageable. Now, this is a time where you shouldn't be afraid to pass.
Now, the West coach, Eric Washington, has coached football for the last 15 years.
Yeah.
He has coached the Woodside High School, College of San Mateo, and he actually won the state championship as an offensive coordinator for the Menlo Atherton High School. So really experienced coaches that are leading these eighth graders.
And it's great that he's able to share that experience with these younger players.
And we have a timeout taken. Yeah, it looks like that timeout is going to be taken by the East. And that's going to be the first timeout of the half for them.
Yes, timeout by the East.
gives them time to come up with a nice little creative play here.
Third and four coming up.
Now it's third and four, so it means the run is definitely still in a possibility here, but it also leaves a chance if the defenders, if you notice the defenders are starting to come up, it leaves an opening for a play action here.
What do you think the coaches are telling their kids at this point? You know what?
Definitely what to be aware of on this play. And also, I imagine for on the east side right there, just a lot, making sure that they stay disciplined. Obviously, they're coming up with the play, so they know that they're prepared for whatever's coming up. And then obviously, for the west side right there, it's just they're obviously going to be prepared for one or the other, either a run or a pass.
Now, West Coast Washington started his own training company called Leith Athletes Journeys in 2015, and he has worked actually with pro athletes such as Devontae Adams from the Green Bay Packers, Nashawn Wright from the Dallas Cowboys, and many high school and college school athletes. And so, again, really senior coaching that these kids are experiencing.
Safe to say those are notable names.
And so we have a false start there on the east, and that's going to push them back 5 yards. And so they were third and five, and now they're going to be about third and call it nine.
Yeah, tough to have that coming off a timeout as well. Third and nine, it could make the play a little more predictable here. Now, if they really want to catch the team off guard, if they really want to stay disciplined too, they would run the ball here. But don't be afraid to pass it here. You also have some great targets out there. Notable mention, A.J. Rangel, who we mentioned is the first overall pick of this draft.
They have one there.
Down at the bottom.
Okay, East has the ball third and nine. Ball's on their own 31-yard line.
Staying disciplined with the run.
Handoff to number eight. E.K. McLemore, but number 15,
tossed to McLemore over the right side.
Jadis Lucky from the Hayward Lancers got him pretty quickly. He was able to get the stop on that.
Also number two again, the safety, Kamani.
And Kamani Kiani, number two from the San Jose Hit Squad, also helped on that.
Great read by the defender there, noticing it was an outside run and just pursuing and closing the gap, making sure he wouldn't get to the outside. Had to force him to cut back inside.
So they bring special teams out, and so with that, fourth down and six. Number 44, Cesar Jimenez. .313 left in this first quarter. High kick that's going to bounce out of bounds about the 44-yard line. West 44-yard line. We'll see where they actually spot that.
Goes out of bounds on the right side. It's going to be good field position for the West.
45, pretty close actually.
Yeah, we'll call it 45,
give or take.
So good field position for the West. Again, they're already on the score. 6-0 is 3:06 left.
Now this is a big drive for both teams here. It's big to get a stop here for the East right here. Try to get some of that momentum back. And for the West, you just want to keep pouring it on.
So if you're the West coach, how are you going to try and encourage your kids to keep that momentum going or to restart right now?
Well, for the West right now, you don't just keep playing your game right now. You know, you have the ball. You already have a lead. This is where you keep playing your game. Obviously, the run game has been working. It's just staying disciplined, staying away from those penalties. Oh, here we go.
Long throw intended for Jesse Deanna. No flag on that, and so that's going to be incomplete out of bounds. Bringing up second and 10, ball and 45.
Interesting no call, but also still a good play by 19, being in position, being ready for that.
It'll be second and 10.
That is Diego Arias. One high safety, corners playing off. We might have a cover three here.
Second and 10. Hand off to Diego Hernandez.
Great tackle.
He gets tackled by number 20, Chase Cahoon, and 33 Landon Weichel.
Cahoon's already making a name for himself in this game. Also, Weichel, another great tackle there. But what was great about that was the play design. Having that motion brought 55 out, so he had to stay disciplined, watch the motion, and allowed that inside run.
Bring up third and seventh right now. You see on the replay here.
That motion right there, you see 55 had to be ready for that, and then great run again. Strong running again from Diego Hernandez. We've been seeing that all night so far.
Lots of good play reading by the defense.
Definitely. Being ready.
And these are not simple plays. These are high school or even college level plays.
Yeah. Good step up in the pocket.
Tries to get out. Makes it a little past midfield.
And he's picking up some yards there.
Brandon Mann, quarterback carry, but he gets tackled by number 66, Antonio Villegas.
Great effort on that play.
And that's going to bring up fourth and about 3 yard lines on the 47. We're going to have to see what the West is going to do here. You're almost in fourth down territory.
Also, it's in the end, too, you're kind of in no man's land. This is an area where you feel like you can go for it. It's fourth and short. You know, you could trust your defense. I definitely, and obviously it looks like right here they're going for it. But great effort on the play. Also, decisiveness again. We talked about it. Going 1-2-3 and then just making sure you run. Don't just sit there in the pocket.
And it looks like they are going to go for it.
That run game has been
fourth and
well.
Three.
And they stick with it.
Hand off to number 8. E.C. McLemore, and tackled by number 33.
And we talked about it.
Weichel on the tackle, and that is not enough. So the East will take over on downs, and they're going to take it over on their own 46-yard line.
Great job for that defense, being prepared for the run. They knew it was fourth and short, and they know they've been staying disciplined with the run, closing the gaps, making sure they couldn't break loose on an outside run. Also, you had a couple of the defenders being ready on the outside in case of a outside cutback.
Now, the East Coast
full run commit.
East coach Jamar is a 4-time One Vision All-Star Game champion, back to defend his title. We talked about that. In his history of coaching this game, he has had 4 titles, 4 MVP players from his team, numerous athletes who went straight to their high school varsity teams, along with some who are now playing in college.
Seems like a Bill Belichick of this league.
Handed off to E.C. McLemore, but he get tackled by Santino Berrigan on the Morgan Hill Raiders.
Great tackle there.
And we're going to see how far E.K. made it. E.K. made it about a little bit of forward progress, actually about 4 yards. That's going
to
bring up 2nd and 6 right now.
Yeah. Great way to shed that block there by Santino, my apologies. Great break.
Handoff to number 8, E.K. McLemore, but he gets tackled by Isaiah Pinnell, number 6 and number 31.
Isaiah Pinnell.
E.C. Tugumusu.
Yeah. Great way to finish off that hit, but also a great run there by McLemore.
And with that, we have the end of the first quarter. So with the 12 minutes of football played,
still a lot of
right
football
now,
left.
The West leads 6-0.
6-0.
Now, we talked about East Coach Jamar Julian's coaching accomplishments, but he's actually a San Jose State alumnus. He actually played running back for the NFL for the Kansas City Chiefs. Mm-hmm. And not only is he a bit of a football legend around here, I think he really serves a wonderful role model for these kids and athletes. I mean, to have them playing a game, coached by a former NFL player, and the life skills, not only the football skills, but the life skills that this coach, all these coaches stress with these kids. I just think it's tremendous.
Oh, yes. And any level of football experience is experience, and especially when you get to the NFL level. And it's also great for the kids to know, seeing some of these guys from their area who made it to the NFL definitely gives them a lot of inspiration as well.
One of the things that we talked about with both coaches beforehand when they're describing what the offense we're going to play, they told us we're going to play a variety of plays. And they said, you're going to see some things that you would not normally see from eighth graders. And I have to agree with them. I've seen some stuff that I would be impressed if I were looking at JV even varsity high school.
Definitely, and I love the use of motions so far. Motions is a big way to tell what defensive coverage they're in, if it's man, if it's zone. And also, I've seen a couple play adjustments too in the middle of the play, which is good. It's good for those quarterbacks. It's good for the entire offense to get that experience of making adjustment audibles on the fly.
Okay, East ball, third and about two. The ball is on the 46-yard line.
This would be a good time to play action, but they have been staying disciplined with the run. Good play action.
Long bomb caught by Perrion, caught by number one, A.J. Rangel.
It was the perfect time.
A.J.'s got that, and we've got a touchdown.
Or first down.
Oh, almost.
At the nine. It was a perfect time to go with the play action there. You knew the defense was going to come up. We even saw a blitz from the linebacker there. Great throw and a great route there by A.J. Rangel. Seeing that he had it outside leverage from the cornerback, he was able to take it inside on the post. And that's what you say with A.J. Rangel. A 6'1 receiver, had the best vertical and the best 40 time. That's a hard receiver to cover.
And number one from the West, Perrion Williams, able to bring him down for the stop, prevent the touchdown. That fooled us a little bit.
Great tackle there at the end of the play. Great effort.
So it's going to be first and goal. The ball is about on the 8-yard line now.
And when you run a play action like that, it keeps the defense disciplined, makes them still have to be aware of the pass.
Handoff.
Wow.
To EK McLemore, and we have another touchdown.
I have to say, both of these running backs so far, McLemore, and what I'm seeing from Diego Hernandez and McLemore is amazing right now with how hard they are running through the hole. They are shedding off tackles. They keep those legs driving, and it worked there for a touchdown. And that is a drive that you need right there for the East. Great cutback. Great seal-off block, too, by the O-line. Yeah, that was 49 and 97 there, able to make a seal-off block on number 52, which gave him the chance to cut inside.
He found the crease and went right into the end zone.
Right there. And a strong run.
And so it looks like the East is going to try for 2 points on this one.
Big 2 points here.
There's a flag that comes down, actually a couple flags.
Looks like it's a PI.
Looks like we're going to have a pass interference.
Yeah, we have some guesses that it may be pass interference, but we'll wait till for the official ruling. And it is pass interference, and that's going to go against.
That's big. Makes it a shorter distance.
We're going to have an untimed down right now.
Probably half the distance to the goal.
Replayed that two-pointer, half the distance to the goal.
It's good here for the East because it gave them a chance to see how they line up in a kind of a two-point conversion situation, and it also allows them to move the ball up here.
So they're going to spot that on the 2-yard line.
Makes the run a lot more dangerous here.
QB sneak number 18.
And
that is good 2 points. And so, despite falling behind very quickly, the East comes back, leads 8-6 with 11:20.
I know it's weird to say you don't expect a QB sneak in the goal line situation, but when you're out from the two, definitely something that could catch a team off guard. And it was a great play there by number 18 as he was able to fight through and keep fighting for yards, because this isn't 1 yard that he needs to gain. These are 2 yards now, two long yards.
And we can see in the replay, just makes his way right on through.
That was a big 2-point conversion there. Now the East has full momentum. They went down, they were down 6-0, but a great way for this team to bounce back and be able to take the lead even. Now let's see if the West can do the same.
One of the themes of One Vision is really making this tangible for the players.
Yes.
And if you work hard, you can be a part of something bigger, and you can touch it, you can feel it.
Yes.
Really leave your mark, and we're seeing that among all these kids.
And the thing about the game of football that I love is it's more so about the process than it is the outcome. those hard work habits and that the effort that they put in into the game of football, it helps and it applies to everything in life, not just football. Great tackle.
The kick returned by number 6.
Elijah Malcolmore. Another great tackle.
Diego Hernandez with that. Excuse me, I think that's Ikaya McLemore with that big hit.
Yeah, we can see right there. I see a canal. Big hit in on him.
Yeah, big hit. It looks like it also drew a flag.
Yeah, we'll see.
It was a great job there by Powell being able to recover the kick. So, those are the hard ones to recover. When it keeps bouncing like that, it can obviously bounce high. It's kind of unpredictable. It's like a ground ball in baseball. Great job recovering, and also a good job by McLemore being able to finish the hit. McLemore playing with a lot of intensity right now and physicality.
So penalty, we're going to re-kick this ball. Let's go back to the 35-yard line. Changing kicker number 44. Cesar Menez. That gets picked up by Kamea Giannini from the San Jose Hiscard. And he gets tackled by A.J. Rangel, number 1.
Tackle by number 1.
But he was able to make it all the way out to about the 48-yard line.
Great play there. Able to recover it quickly, so it gave him time to adjust and see the field and then see whichever lane he needed to take. Also, great decisiveness, too. Didn't wait. Just took the lane, took whatever he saw.
49-yard line.
Now you got a great field position here and a drive where you can get and you can steal that energy right back.
First and 10. Diego Hernandez got the ball, but he gets stopped pretty quickly. He got tackled by Chase Cahoon and Antonio Villegas.
Chase Cahoon again and Antonio Villegas with another great play there. They were ready for the run this time, as it seems like Diego Hernandez has been able to pop up some big runs here, but a great job being able to shed that block and get that first initial hit, and Cahoon was able to finish it off.
Diego has been able to, as you can see, get about a yard out of this. That's going to bring up second and 9. Some really good defense we're seeing in this.
Definitely. Great read so far. Again, one high safety. Corners are playing off a little bit. Looks like another cover 3.
Long throw. Ooh. Almost picked, but not quite.
Attempts the big deep throw to Aaron Meyer. Almost intercepted. Great attempt.
Stefania Latini looked like he had a hand on it. Couldn't quite bring it in.
That's picture-perfect safety play that right there. Dropping back, making sure you keep your feet moving. Follow the quarterback's eyes. And when he saw that the quarterback was zoning in on that left side of the field, he was able to adjust and almost make a great play. Still a great play, though. He was able to disrupt the ball.
And for eighth graders, we're seeing some really strong arms here. We're
very strong arms.
Very good long throws.
Yes.
Third and 9 now. West has the ball.
That's a great rollout pass.
Really good catch.
Great pass
by Sinai Thomas. And he gets tackled by Jesse Deanna.
Number 17, Sinai Thomas.
But that's going to be enough for a first down.
Now, great play by Thomas there, being able to sell that streak, making that quarterback back off, knowing it was cover 3, but also the throw. I love throws on the run right there, especially with pressure in his face, throwing to his right, making sure he kept his hips disciplined, and then just was able to cut it loose.
I also like how Sinai had the presence of mind to try and stay in bounds.
Stay in bounds.
And see if he could put that extra effort to get a few yards on this play.
Definitely, and knew where the line of scrimmage, or knew where the yards to gain were. Great route.
First and 10 for the West.
Another motion here.
Handoff to E.K. McLemore, but he gets tackled.
Number 7, Matthew Pitt. Number 20, Chase Cahoon.
correction, Diego Hernandez, and he gets tackled by Matthew Pitt.
Matthew Pitt with a little bit of help again from Chase Cahoon. But Matthew Pitt there, great read. It looks like they're really starting to crack it down here on the run a little bit, covering up those lanes. What's really impressive is the linebackers and the safeties are coming up quick. So while these D linemen are getting blocked out, the safeties, if they come up quick, they're able to plug up that gap really fast.
Yeah, EK had that ball. He tried to put that second or third effort in.
Yes, always something out of it. We've been seeing that all night from Diego Hernandez.
Ball sitting on the east 39-yard line.
I'm loving these motions so far.
Hand off to Diego Hernandez again. And we tackled by number 34. Ryan Pupak. And we may have an injury timeout here.
Hate to see this.
Hernandez working hard for those yards. Picks up another few. It's going to be 3rd and 7.
Now, it was a great play there by Daniel Hernandez. He was it was a bit of a kind of a suspect handoff there, but he was able to still recover the ball there. You see it at the end. Make sure he still had good security of the ball and able to gain a couple yards. And it's great to see 55 right now getting up off the field nice and quick.
Yeah. And you see the coaching here. When somebody's hurt, you see the respect to the players, everybody taking a knee on both sides.
Yes.
A lot of discipline in these teams and a lot of respect for the game and sportsmanship. That's exactly right.
In the end, we still want everyone out here to get out of here healthy, of course.
Okay, West has the ball on the east 35-yard line.
They're lining up quick, too.
3rd and 7 right now.
I like this, lining up quick, making that defense trying to be a little confused there as they have to hurry up on the ball. Corners are playing off again. They could give that room if the receivers get to the line again and sell that streak. Curls and outs can work here. Another rollout. Oh my.
Brandon Mann scrambling to stay on his feet, evading lots and lots of tackles.
Almost too
finally, number 11, Shai Green, but we do have a flag that's down.
This could be a,
we may have to look at a replay in this to see how many different tackles did he evade.
Great scramble by the quarterback. Very talented quarterback play here tonight on both sides of the ball.
So one, I'm telling you, the way these eight that's going to be, the penalty's going to be holding offense, so incredible. That's going to put them back some.
See if they accept it. It would still give them third.
Another one, another one. I'm counting four.
Count a couple spin moves that worked there.
Maybe five.
Now, it was a streak out concept. It was kind of a mini flood concept there. What I love about it is he didn't want to force the ball. He saw the linebacker was there to cover the out route as they were prepared for it this time, and the streak route was covered by the safety as well.
We've said it before. This is not the first time you're going to see these kids. You're
going
to see these kids in high school. You're going to see some of them in college. You're going to see them a lot of different places.
And who knows when we may see some of them in the pros as well. So they are going to decline it. It's going to make it fourth down. And
fourth down. Penalty was declined, as you're right, Andro, but that's going to leave fourth and about seven. They're going to spot the ball back on the 35-yard line.
So penalty declined.
On the defense.
8:42 left in this half.
At the 35-yard
defense needs to be ready to make sure that they don't get those curls and out routes going right there, kind of to the line to gain. These corners are playing off right now. Another rollout. Out route again. Perfect.
And we've got a completion by number 17, Sinai Thomas. And that's going to be just enough good awareness of the line of game for another first down for the West.
It was the same route that he did last time on third down earlier in this drive. He was able to sell that streak, stem his route, and then take it to the outside. And what he did that was great, too, was he didn't push himself to the out-of-bounds lines. He kind of sat in the hole and made sure that the quarterback was able to have enough time to throw him the ball. Also, another great throw on the run there.
We're seeing some tremendous throwing by Brandon Mann.
Yeah.
Really.
Throws on the run are not easy throws.
Making
that
his
can't
target.
Be taken for granted. it's really impressive how well he's throwing to his right, and it's, they obviously trust him as they're going to the left as well. See if they get back to the run here.
Short pass.
Pass intended for Meyer. Incomplete.
Intended for Aaron Meyer from the Menlo Atherton Vikings.
Just one of those throws that fell short, but you know what? That play is there, and I definitely think they should come back to that at some point. That was a great play action there. They had the defense expecting that they were going to go for a run. The linebackers were ready for it, and that screen was there, and I definitely expect it to be there still.
Yeah, that was just a bit underthrown, but again, you know, I'm thinking tonight that's probably the first missed pass we've seen from Mann tonight.
Yeah.
I mean, again, for an eighth grader, this is just outstanding performance.
Exactly. You don't see many eighth graders making throws like that anyway.
Second and 10, 8:08 left in the half.
Trips again. Bit of a miscommunication there by the defense. And
we have a flag down, and that's going to be a false start. So that's going to cost him 5 years yards. We're going to go from second and 10 to second and 15.
These flags are building up for the West. These can be drive killers there if they keep adding up like this. They are able to, the West so far has been able to make efficient drives. It's just really the penalties that have been holding them back so far. They can.
And we have a timeout.
They can kind of tune up on that discipline. We could definitely see this offense be moving the ball much smoother.
We have a timeout on the field.
Timeout taken by the West. I think this is the first timeout they've taken.
Second and long, this is an interesting situation. Don't try to get all your yards back here in one play. Definitely try. I would probably try to go with a run play here or even a short pass. Try to gain some of those yards. Try to make it third and manageable. And especially because it seems like they have four downs to play with anyways.
We talked about what these players are learning. I mean, you talked about their learning, what they learned in high school. They learned about huddle.
Yeah.
They learned about nutrition, hydration, keeping healthy. Really, the whole month has been a series of classes that have gone through in addition to practice.
Yeah, it's not, and that's what I love about this program. It's not just practices. It's not just focusing on just the fundamentals in the game of football, but many other things outside of it, as well as health, nutrition, as you mentioned before already.
One Vision CEO and founder, Aaron Noriega, has said that if a kid can touch it and see it, then they will aspire to achieve it. And so this is really about these kids touching and seeing what they can do with hard work and effort and teamwork.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, second and 15.
No dream is out of reach.
West has the ball. A little bit more than 8 minutes left in this half.
Nice little trio set there on the short side as well. Safety's playing really far back here.
Oh, and that was
great catch.
A good catch, an outstanding catch. Aaron Meyer was able to bring that catch in. And they was tackled by Shai Green and Stefania.
As I mentioned in the play, they went trio on the short side. This gave the chance for the receiver and the corner to be one-on-one on the far side of the field. And now it was a throw that was underthrown, but that's what you do when you trust your guy to go one-on-one against that defender.
So all said and done, he's going
to
be going to mark that on the 5-yard line. First and goal for the West.
Football is a game of matchups right there, and he took his matchup versus the opponents. Despite the setback, it's a very good drive here.
Handoff to Diego Hernandez, but Diego gets stopped by A.J. Rangel and a whole flock of players from the East. And we're going to see. Looks like he made a little bit of progress, maybe about 3 yards of forward progress there. That's going to bring up second and goal. Ball
strong
on the,
run
2-yard
after
line.
Contact. Strong run after contact, able to see the hole and keep fighting through. Again, seal off blocks by this O-line have been great so far.
Hand off to Diego Hernandez.
Here he is again.
Tackled by Chase Cahoon and Nathaniel Benuelos. And
I've heard this duo a lot already.
Yeah, they're holding him back. That's going to be now third and goal.
Yes.
Maybe a yard on the play. The ball's going to be spotted. Let's call it the 1 yard, maybe the 2 yard line.
Now these are big because now you're getting to the situation now where the offense might start thinking about having to throw it here, especially with the way they've stopped the run twice now.
Two good stops when it was first and goal.
Got one-on-one coverage on both sides.
QB sneak by Brandon Mann.
Mann attempts the sneak.
And I think he's going to lose a yard or two from that one. He was tackled by Ryan Pupak.
Great tackle again. This is the linebackers making a great read here. Not being fooled by the QB draw that was happening on this play. Staying disciplined, keeping their eyes on the court.
So what are you going to do for the coach now for the West? You're down by two. Fourth and goal.
Well, you ran.
Yeah, you can see that D-line just saw that coming and had to stop.
Now, this is where it can get interesting. Be kind of a guessing game. Now, you ran it three times. Do you stay disciplined with it, or do you try to make a pass here? If I was the West here, I would definitely try to. We already saw how one of our receivers, number three, was able to make a great play there. So now, do we try it again here? Goal line fade.
Or do you go for the, the 3 points, a little chip shot here? And at least get yourself up in the game.
Definitely. These points are huge now. But it looks like both teams are going all in on going for it on fourth down. And
back in the first quarter, the West missed that two-point conversion, so they're down by two.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting here to see how they play out this.
We've seen this game in past years, and sometimes we've seen a bit of a blowout. Tonight, it's not a blowout. We have a real football game of two sets of kids that are playing their heart out, and this is a great Saturday night.
Strong defensive matchups as well. But also, we're seeing many great things. The offenses right now are starting to wake up here a little later in the game, as we talked about, just having to get those early nerves out. Now, remember, this is the same formation where they threw to Aaron Meyer last time, as they have single coverage one-on-one on the left side.
Okay, the West brought the offense on, so it looks like they're going to go for it, not try and attempt a field goal.
No field goals here.
QB drop right in the middle, and touchdown for the West.
Brandon Mann
runs that into the end zone.
We've been seeing it
on fourth down.
Gutsy play call. We've been seeing a lot already today with the aggressiveness of how Mann is running. But what I love about it is in this quarterback draw, they kind of saw that he moved a little bit to the right. That slight movement made it seem like, especially with how much they've been rolling out today.
I like the extra effort also at the end zone there. He could have easily been stopped on the 1 yard line, but really pushed through actually into the end zone.
Seeing that from everyone today, though, too, I must say.
I'm trying.
All these runners are just fighting through for extra yards. It's really great to see.
I've seen high school varsity football teams with a lot less effort.
Yes.
And these eighth grade kids are showing us tonight.
Oh, it is awesome.
And I'll mention a few NFL teams, which we shall not name.
We'll leave those ones for the ESPN analysis to make.
A little out of our league, but the principle remains the same. These kids are doing great.
Great football.
All right, looks like they're going to go for the two-point conversion here. Oh, that looks like it was tipped by number 10 on the defense.
Sefania
Alatini got the tip, and he's able to get 0 points on that. So with 5:41 left in the second quarter, the West again takes the lead 12-8 over the East.
Yeah, great play by Alatini again, making sure he stuck with his receiver and he was in position to make that play. He wasn't fooled by that little outside move to a slant right there. And also, I like the play idea there, Bo, because you already worked once with the quarterback draw, so they made it seem like it was another quarterback draw, especially with the way he was going easy at first, cut up again, and then was able to make that throw there right at the end.
Now, we're also seeing a very mature move by the defense on both teams here. They are quick quickly learning the opposing team's offense.
Definitely. They're,
you know, the quality of the stops that we're seeing just within the past two quarters tells me that these kids are paying attention. They're looking at the preferences of the offense and quite frankly, defending it.
Definitely. And they're staying disciplined. The biggest thing on defense is staying disciplined, doing your job. And that's what I'm seeing a lot from these defensive players right now.
Isi Tugumusu, the kicker. Number 10, Stefania Alatini. And number 20, Chase Cahoon in the backfield for the return.
Alatini and Cahoon back deep for the return. Tugumusu on the kickoff.
Good kick that's going to land about the 30-yard line. Scooped up by number 20, Chase Cahoon. And Chase is still on his feet, just with a double and triple effort, makes it all the way out to about to the 41-yard line. Finally tackled by Michael Vasquez from the Gilroy Browns.
I mean, we've been talking about
it all night. Dixon from the Creekside Warriors.
Yes, great tackles. I mean, we've been talking about it all night, that extra effort on the runs, how they keep fighting for yards even after the first and second tackles. Puts them in good field position here. Again, anytime you can start a drive on your own 40, that's definitely a good start. Now let's see, they kind of ended well with the pass here. Let's see if they kind of commit more to the run.
First and 10 for the East. They're going to try and even things out before.
Watch out for the press coverage on the top of the field. Good motion.
Handoff to number 8. E.K. McLemore, but he gets brought down by Santino Berrigan.
Yeah, great tackle there by Santino. Way to be fearless there, especially with how hard McLemore's been running all game.
You notice he was able to get about 8 yards out of that, bringing up second. It looks like they can spot the ball exactly on midfield.
Yep. Again, that motion is so huge as it gets that edge defender to just slightly be disciplined and having to stay ready for the outside. It allows that running back to kind of cut inside and give him that bit of a lane.
Hand off to E.K. McLemore. And number 2,
yet again,
Kaimani Kianea.
Great tackle there.
From the San Jose Hit Squad again on the tackle.
Also a great run by McLemore there, getting that first down.
But was able to get enough yards on that first down for the East.
At the 48-yard line of the West.
You know, other than maybe one pick that we saw in the first quarter, I'm trying to think. I really haven't seen these teams make any real big mistakes.
No, it's been pretty much perfect football so far that we've been seeing. Great.
End around on number 44. Open field tackle, however, by number 1, Perrion Williams.
Now they've been
Perrion was able to stop him for a loss, tackle for a loss of about 7 yards there. That's going to go back into East territory, and they're going to spot that at 46-yard line.
Yeah, I love the idea of the play call because they've been using the motion a lot as a disguise, and this time they try to use it as a run. But just, again, we've been talking about it all night, how these defenders are just doing their job. They're not overcommitting to a play. They're sticking to their lanes and doing what their job is. And Perrion Williams staying on the outside, being ready in case a play like that would happen. And he was ready when it came.
All right, second and 16.
Schutz formation.
And a little laundry on the field. We're going to guess either it's encroachment or foul start based on the timing. But wait, yes, it's a false start against the East. So,
miscommunications there at the beginning of the line. It just didn't seem like they all had the idea of what the play was.
It's going to be a second and 21 now. It just keeps on being pushed back.
Costly mistake so far.
Second and 21.
Again, the biggest thing, though, is you can't give up on this drive right now. You could still second down. You can still get some yards here, even to give yourself a third and manageable. And if you do good on that, maybe even fourth and short.
Well, quite frankly, the way that these kids are throwing the ball.
Yeah.
You know.
20 yards is nothing.
Very doable.
Yes.
Long throw. Almost picked. By number 20, Joseph Patterson had eyes on the ball, couldn't quite bring it in. So that's going to fall incomplete. Again, that's going to bring up third and 21 now.
Great job by Patterson there, making sure he turned his hip and turned towards the ball. He didn't keep his eye on the receiver, and he gave himself a chance to look at the ball and be able to make a play, to locate that ball and make a play.
2:31 left in the half. West leads 12-8 over the East.
Now we have third and long. This could be an interesting play.
Quarterback draw.
Ooh.
He got tackled by number 28. Santino Berrigan.
That was a great run by Franzino there. A chance to break away, but also just, it was just an amazing tackle there by Santino.
Able to pick up about 8 yards, but that's still going to leave fourth and 14. Ball is going to be spotted on the 48-yard line.
This is giving him really good field position if you don't convert. What a play there by Santino, though. Because that was a run there that if he broke that tackle, he could have taken it and possibly even gained possibly a first down there. Great speed there. Look at that, closing out and being able to make that tackle.
I love the vision, and I love the ability to sense the fact that there's an opportunity to run the ball.
Yes.
Not getting so focused on the particular player. You know, it's at least another fourth down. It looks like they're going to go for it.
Interesting. Now, again, the one guy to look out for is Rangel Jr. right there at the bottom of the screen. He's a tall target and a guy who's always a mismatch, it seems.
Looking for the throw and running all the way through and
wow,
able to get the first down for the East.
Let's see if we got enough.
An amazing play there by the quarterback, Andrew Franzino. Now, it was an amazing play. He looked at his read, saw no one was there, and then took it and ran, and he was committed to the run. But we got to give credit to this O-line. This O-line held their blocks, even on the outside, when he took it to the end. You see how they seal it out to where he was able to move to the left, and he still had a lot of time.
Yeah, Franzino saw it, and he's also had the sense where the line of Guinness, and so that is a first down.
Great play by the
O-line. Got the conversion, and now the ball's going to be spotted on the 38-yard line, on the West 38-yard line.
Great pass blocking, sealed that defensive line to the right side, and great play by Franzino, just pocket awareness, moving to the left, giving himself time, and then when saw nothing was there, took off and ran for that first down.
So East is going to take their second timeout of the half, about 1 minute and 33 seconds left, and again, West is leading 12-8, so East wants to walk into that locker room at halftime with the lead. So they're going to take the timeout to figure out what they need to do.
Yeah, this is a huge drive here. Now, if I'm not mistaken, it was the West that started off with the ball first. So this makes this drive really important here because the East can drive down, score, and still get the ball back at halftime.
That's right.
And it gives them a chance because right now if they score a touchdown, they take the lead with the two-point conversion that they've converted. And now it would give them a chance to add on to that lead possibly at the start of the half. So this is a huge drive and a huge chance for the West team to go into the halftime with a lead.
East will be receiving the second half, so...
That's going to be interesting. 1 minute and 33 seconds is a lot of time, especially because first downs do stop the clock. You just got to make sure you don't trade yardage for time. It can't be short yardage for an excessive amount of time.
First and 10. A fumble on the ball. number 54 was able to get the tackle on that. And recovered by 49 on the offense.
52.
Let's see that one again.
East
is able to recover and maintain possession.
He covered that outside, so he knew he made sure that he wasn't able to roll.
Scrambling.
Also, they did recover, though. That was a great recovery there.
Senatula Veya really with the pressure.
Yes. It was like a QB contain. He was able to take that outside, and he was able to make sure that he was ready in case he rolled out, and he did, and he was right there able to make a play. What a great play there.
Senatula Veya is from the East Palo Alto Mastodons. But that, unfortunately, with that tackle for the loss for the sack, and that's really one of the first sacks we've seen this entire game, which is slightly amazing, that's going to leave them second and, say, 25, really long.
And we just
got a flag.
We just talked about not trading yardage, short yardage for time, and how you lost yardage.
So we have a delay of game that's going to go against the East. And so make that, we'll just call it second and really long at this point.
And now we only have 27 seconds left on the clock. So a lot of time has chipped away because of that sack.
What play are you going to call if you're the coach for the East at this point?
At this point, I wouldn't try to go for a big shot right here. I'd try to screen pass or a run play. Right now, at this point, it's kind of getting into miracle mode. I might want to take it into the half, knowing that you do still get the ball back at halftime. You don't want to force something here, and possibly, so a screen pass. Ooh, 52 again.
Quick pass is in for Rangel.
Pass was intended for Rangel.
There he is again. This is what you love to see from a D lineman. It's not just making plays on quarterback pressure, but being able to read when there's a screen pass coming. He was able to have a quick reaction, see that the pass was coming his direction, and be able to make a tip right there. Almost intercepted it, too.
And number 52 out there, Senatula Veya, again, got a hand on that, tipped that pass.
See, I wonder if a play like that, especially with how dangerous it was, almost intercepted, I wonder how conservative this makes the East go now. Because remember, the last thing you want to do is give them a turnover and possibly give the West now good field position to end this half. See what they do here.
Long throw. Almost caught.
Brandino deep down the right side to Rangel.
Almost caught by A.J. Rangel. Couldn't quite hold on to it. That's going to bring up fourth and long at this point. And there's 11 seconds left in this half.
Great play there by the safety, number two.
Reach for it. And I'm going to give some credit there.
Carry on Williams and Kaimani.
Yes, for disrupting that play.
Yeah. Great job on both sides there. And now I can't say I hate that play call, because in the end, A.J. Rangel's a guy that you could feel like you could throw it up to, give it a shot, and you'd like to think that most of the time he can't come down with a pass like that. But that was just great defense overall, the safety reading the eyes and being able to help out there.
Possibly the last play of the half. We'll see. So we're going to punt the ball.
Good punt.
And that's going to roll out of bounds at about the 20 with 9 seconds left.
Now, if you're the West, I would be very content right now taking a knee going into the halftime. You had a great stop there at the end of the half, making sure that the East wouldn't have an opportunity to go into the halftime with the lead.
And if you're the West, you're winning, and you're happy to walk in with that.
Happy to walk in with that lead.
We reminded you at the beginning of the show that the East has been undefeated in this series, and so the West has to be feeling pretty good about itself.
Yes.
Although, we have two more quarters of football.
Yep.
And really, this is anybody's game at this point.
Yep. And again, you could tell with these guys over here on the West side, they're not worried about what's happened in the past. They know that they're a completely different team. They're confident in themselves.
Right. Looks like they're not in the victory formation. new quarterback for the West, number 5, Michael Vasquez.
Michael Vasquez, that quarterback. Little trickery.
Hand off to 17. And he's going to run out of bounds. Still a few seconds left on the clock. But they're saying no. We're going to see if they stop the clock. Whether it's, no, they're going to keep the clock rolling. And that may just end the half for us right there. Michael Vasquez, his nickname is the Hulk.
And that will run out the clock.
And that is your half.
And that is the half. And so after two quarters of football, the West leads 12-8 over the East.
I like the bold play call to end the half. You know, give it a shot. See if you can break something loose. And if not, he did a smart play there, running out of bounds, making sure he wouldn't have a chance to turn
the ball.
All right, we will join you at the beginning of the second half.
Mr. Noriega, 20 minutes.
Exciting football.
Confirmation, yes. Thank you.
Okay, welcome to the second half of the First Vision 8th Grade All-Star Game. West leads 12-8 over the East. Very exciting football game for any age level, even though these are 8th graders. This is really good play.
Well, yes, it's just great to watch some of these 8th graders play at such a high level. Great discipline. We've been seeing it from the D-line and the O-line especially, too.
We should give some recognition to the coaches. You know, for the West, we talked about how Eric Washington is the head coach. Assistant coaches include Ricky Williams, Law Johnson, Avery Hill, Aaron Johnson, and Marquise Reed. For the East, Jamar Julian is the head coach, but Daniel Cruz, Jermaine Baker, Dave Brooks, Eric Wood, Alan Chapman, Darnell Avery, and Daniel King. You know, and anybody's coach football realize it's really a team effort, not only on the field, but also within the coaching ranks.
A great
team here.
Oh, yes, definitely. And especially with how well these defenses have been adjusting, especially how these offenses have improved in the second quarter compared to the first, that definitely has to be given credit to the coaching as well.
Continuing for our officiating tonight, we have Tyrone Murphy, Ronnie Burton, Rod Hunter, Danny Beck, and Eric Smith. That's our officiating crew tonight. And
doing a good job tonight.
Really good.
Well,
so Alejandro, you are a coach for the East. What are you going to do to strategize to start the second half?
Well, the first thing I would do is throw on first down, because you've been so committed to the run, and I'm glad that you're doing that. It might help out at the end. But what you got to do is you got to stay unpredictable. You got to make sure that defense stays disciplined, make sure those safeties play back, because they've been coming up, especially closing those run gaps. And it's making it hard for those runs to break out. So throwing on first down, relying on the play action. Plays like that will help keep the secondary back, keep them disciplined. And it also may lead to more success on your pass plays when you have great receiving core like the East does.
Now, the West is up 4 points, and that's, you know, obviously slightly more.
Yes.
It's a one possession game. Yeah. What are you going to do if you're the West coach?
If I'm the West right now, I keep doing what I'm doing. And the biggest thing that's been hurting the West is they've been moving the ball, but the only thing that's been hurting them is penalties. Staying disciplined. If they can avoid those penalties, they've been moving the ball very well this game. You know, converting third and longs, running the ball. The O-line is definitely getting their push up there in the front line. So they just got to keep doing what they're doing. Stick to their guns. Discipline is huge.
You know, it's getting chillier as we're getting into the night. But I tell you, the energy in the stadium, the parents are here. The community's here, the kids are here. We just feel the warmth of this place despite the cold temperatures outside. Everybody's excited to see these kids play.
Energy staying high, I love it.
All right, we're getting ready to kick, and East is set to receive 20 and 10. Stefania Alatini and Chase Cahoon are set to receive.
And Chase Cahoon's already had a couple good, or one good return already to start this game, so be ready if they go his side again. Here we go.
Picked up by Stefania Alatini, and he actually gets all the way out to midfield. And he gets tackled by
great
number
return.
3 and 8, Aaron Meyer and Diego Hernandez. But that's a great return, and they're already into West territory.
Now, great tackles to save the play there, but what I love about that return is he was committed. The second he got that ball, he just shot straight into the gap. No hesitation. He shot straight ahead. He didn't care if he ran past many of his blockers. He just committed to wherever he was going.
And again,
and fighting for those yards. Again, we talk about hard running there at the end of the play.
And I should also mention, that was a good kick.
Yeah, great kick.
And a great kick for any level, and not to mention just eighth graders.
Yeah, and I imagine that many of these kickers that they have aren't, like, practicing being a kicker, you know?
First and 10, East ball at midfield.
Again, play actions and throws would help.
Number 8's the ball carrier. A.K.A. McLemore, he gets pushed out by Perrion Williams and number 31, E.C. Tugamusu. But he's able to get all the way down to the 29, so that's going to be another first down for the East.
Great outside run by McLemore, but really I just love the blocking there from the O-line, especially from that outside lineman, number 97. Daniel Simpson, he did a great job of holding that lineman on the outside defender, who's 52, who's been doing a great job this game, held him long enough for McLemore to get to the outside. Oh, my God.
McLemore again, tripped up.
Ikea McLemore, the ball carrier, and he got tackled pretty quickly by Amani Giamania.
He has been all over the field tonight, and what I love is he's doing this from the safety linebacker position. He's kind of adjusted. Sometimes he'll go deep into the safety position, but he's been working for the linebacker spot too. But he's reading the gaps and reacting quickly. He's not waiting. He's just shooting and finding the gaps.
Small gain on that. That's going to bring up, not call it second and 10.
Call it second and 9.5.
Is a flag down in the backfield, but I think that's an old flag that they had left there, so we'll just ignore that for the time being.
One ref's going to figure out the missing one.
Branzino under center.
Here we go.
We got a throw.
Ooh.
Oh, intended.
Pattern attempt to number 44.
Number 44, Cesar Jimenez, but number Cesar one, Perrion Jimenez. Williams defended that.
Another great job defending. Perrion Williams
we'll go
already
take a look at the replay on this.
Already had a couple great pass breakups, but what I like about the aggressiveness here is they know Rangel's pulling a lot of attention. He pulled the attention of the safety as well as his own corner. So what this allowed was number 44, Cesar Jimenez, to have a one-on-one chance. And if that ball was just a little not too far ahead, it could have been a great catch. But still great defense, too, just being there from Williams.
All right, back to the action. 3rd and 10 now. Little toss pass to number 8.
McLemore,
but he was tackled by 31. He said Tugamusu, but there's a flag on the field, and we'll see what this flag's about.
Let's see what it is.
It's a big flag here. I got to say, this West team did a good job on this second this drive right here, kind of stalling them out, especially after that first big run. It felt like momentum was on their side. They've done a great job here. Great block, though.
So that's going to be holding against the offense, so that's going to set them back 10 yards. Spot foul, actually, at this level.
Do they choose to accept?
Yeah, looks like they will.
On the offense. Spot foul, so they're going to march it back.
So we're going to go all the way back here
to the
38-yard line, and that's going to bring up 3rd and 20 now. We'll call it 3rd and 19.
Now, if I'm the East here, this still gives you a good chance here. If you can gain about 9 to 10 yards, you still give yourself another down on 4th down.
You know, for both these teams, 10 or 20 yards, we've still seen a significant number of conversions despite, you know, the double sticks.
Yep.
toss to
kind of a toss drop there.
Looks like Ikea
McLemore. We'll see how far Ikea got. I don't think too far. He was brought down by number 28 and number 31, Santino Bergen. Is it Tola Tugumusa and number 9 Denham Powell again?
Now again, I know these D linemen didn't make the full tackle on this play, but what they did that was great was that they sealed off the cutbacks and they kept holding their guy. They didn't allow these guys to break off of them and then get to the linebackers as well on the second level.
All right, so now we have fourth and extra long. Yeah, I guess we're in fourth down territory right now. It makes no sense. Might as well go for it.
Might as well go for it. Kind of in a bit of a no man's land. You know it's too far to make a field goal. And a punt could, while you could possibly down him, there's also a chance it lands in the end zone. It still gives him good field position anyway. But the problem here is that it's very predictable now. The defense can pin their ears back. Corners play off. Makes it a much easier play to defend. Oh, instant penetration. Great seal off, though.
Goes for the sack. Oh, and the ball gets loose, and it's out. Number 28 got the sack. Santino Berrigan, but we'll see who where they're going to claim recovers it.
Either
not
way.
Not a big deal because they're going to lose
turnover
on downs or turnover on the.
But here's the big thing. 52
fumble.
Disrupted that entire play. He got 18 out of the pocket. He got him feeling uncomfortable. That was great pressure there by Senatuli Vea. Again, he's been having a heck of a game. He had that sack there at the end of the first half as well as that pass disruption, and now there was again with pressure there.
And Vea had the presence of mind to obviously scoop up the ball, and so he's going to get slightly better field position at midfield. First and 10 for the West now.
Chance to add on to this big lead they got right now.
Hand off to Diego Hernandez. Diego gets maybe about 5 yards. He got tackled by number 20, Chase Cahoon, and Malaki, and Jesse Deanna.
Great blocks there by Michael Lange and Christopher Unga right there.
That's going to bring up second and 4 as they spot the ball all the way into the East 48-yard line.
We've been seeing Diego Hernandez run hard all game, but this also has to be giving credit a lot to the O-lineman. They are giving him lanes to push through so he gets momentum so that he's able to fight for those extra yards. He has not been tackled behind the line much. That's been given a lot of credit. Another motion here.
Handoff to number 8, Diego Hernandez. He got tackled by number 34, Ryan Pupak, but there is a flag down.
That play could have been much worse. That was a great recovery there on the slip for Hernandez. Able to recover from his
holding
and then cut back.
Against the West there, so against the offense. And we'll see if that moves them out of their own. Yeah. West is going to go back into East territory.
Again, we've been talking about
back in their own territory.
The West have been able to move the ball, but the one thing that's been hurting them so far in this game is penalties. These can be drive killers right here because now you put yourself in second and long.
We got holding on the offense, so it's going to bring the West back.
Got to make it third and manageable.
Second about 13. Swing pass to number 17.
Vasquez swings the ball out to number
Sinai
17.
Thomas. Sinai gets pushed out by number 19, Diego Arias. Diego Arias is from the Milpitas Knights.
Great play there by the quarterback, kind of lulling them to sleep a little bit. After he did the handoff, he kind of stood there, acted like he already handed the ball off, and then throws it to the receiver, Thomas, late. Great way to lull the defender to sleep. And they've been, it's a great play design because they've been using that motion again and again, and they use it to keep that defender honest. And then when they finally played action off of it, you know, the defender was kind of letting that little motion go away.
Ball's going to be placed in the 47-yard line in West territory. Third and 8 right now.
It didn't make it third and manageable here. This is definitely much easier to convert.
All Low snap.
Little trouble there with the snap. Snap was a little
intended pass to number 21.
Intended for number 21,
Jaden Ortiz. Jaden Ortiz intended.
Low pass.
Matthew Pitt on the defense there to disrupt it.
It's going to be fourth and eight.
One thing I got to say, though, is the O-line still was able to recover, because most times on a low snap that the D-line's able to slip through, he had time. He just, next time there's a low snap, Vasquez just needs to relax, settle in the pocket. He has to trust his O-line to still be able to give him time. And they've been doing a great job so far on the passing, on the pass blocking as well as the run block.
So it's interesting here. The West is still on their side of the field.
Yeah.
But it sort of looks like they're going to go for it. You know, we've seen a lot of bold fourth down conversions.
Yeah, a lot.
And it looks like they're going to continue that trend, take the risk.
This is a big risk, though, because you give the West, you give the East a lot of momentum back here if you really don't get this. Great blocking, great seal block.
Quarterback rolling out, and that catch by number three. But we'll see if they do that. Arian Meyer, but we have a flag down on the field.
They are just automatic.
They are moving the stick, so obviously they're just going to call that a completion. We'll see what the flag is about.
They are just automatic with these rollout passes they've been doing so far. Now, a great seal that block right there by number 11 and number 8, the running back right
Personal
there.
Personal foul against the East.
Again, that's to be given credit to. That seems like a receiver right there blocking a DN right there, and then the running back to help chip. But these throw, on the runs and these out routes have just been succeeding so far, especially on third and longs like we've been seeing all game.
So that personal foul is going to be a 15-yard penalty.
Yeah.
And so that's going to give the West obviously much better field position. And with that, they're going to move that all the way down to the 20.
Again, Meyer,
first and 10 now for the West as they move into the red zone here. Number eight has the ball, Diego Hernandez. And I don't think they got. He was tackled by number 20, Chase Cahoon.
Cahoon in on that tackle.
And also Ryan Pupak.
Great tackles there by the D-line. They're able to shed their blocks and be able to cover the lanes, finally putting a stop to this run game that's been succeeding so far early on.
With forward progress, game about a yard, second and nine.
Again, the biggest thing that this East defense needs to do is they've been putting them in third and fourth down long situations. They just need to be able to stop them now. Ooh, uh-oh.
Little bobble on the snap there. The quarterback.
Colton Hyder right there with a great play, being able to.
Michael Vasquez able to hold on to the ball.
Michael Vasquez holding on to it, but Colton Hyder being able to get inside and get pressure to be able to put pressure on him to make sure that he actually had to lay down on the ball, not being able to pick it up and still try to make a play.
That's going to bring up third and 12.
My apologies, that was Daniel Simpson right there making the play.
Daniel Simpson from the Morgan Hill Raiders.
Again, third and long. You have to be able to stop him here.
Catch by number three, Arian Meyer. Arian makes his way all the way down, tiptoeing on the sideline, taking that tightrope. He got pushed out by Diego Arias. But still, Arian was able to, let's see where they're going to spot that.
Very close to that first down. It's going to be about fourth and one for the West.
Almost a first down. It's about fourth and maybe half a yard there.
I like this screen call. Look at they keep reading that they're going cover three, so they know the corners are playing off a little bit. So it gives them room to make these short passes and give these talented receivers a chance to run after catch, and that's what they've been succeeding on doing so far. Again, this receiving duo of Meyer and Thomas right now has been working very well for this West team.
All right, fourth and one. Obviously going
Vasquez and Hernandez
for either the touchdown or the conversion.
QB draw, number five.
QB drawn. Michael Vasquez. And Michael is able to get the first down. So first down for the West.
Strong run there.
Yet another fourth down conversion.
Fourth down conversion. Again, this West team is putting them in situations they like. They just need to convert I mean, this East team is putting them in situations they like, fourth down and third long third downs, but they just need to convert.
4:44 left in this third quarter. First down, first and goal, ball on the 7.
This West O-line, though, needs to be given a lot of credit right now with how they're pushing the D-line up front.
Stand by, refs. We're having issues with the
little clock issues here.
It's not moving.
I can tell you, having worked high school football games, the most difficult job in the stadium is to run the clock. It's the most highest pressure job there is.
The clock never seems to work with you either sometimes.
It's going to give these defense a chance to get a little bit of a breath after a series of plays.
Now, we saw the last time that the West was in a goal line situation. They committed 4 run plays in a row. QB draw, and then a run after that, and then still finishing it off with another QB draw to finish off the play. So let's see if the West stays as committed. What can really fool them, though, is if they go with the play action here. These receivers have been having their way so far.
Either between Michael Vasquez, the quarterback, or some of the action we saw previously from Brandon Mann, though, you know, typically you don't see it this level, but throwing is a very viable option for both of these teams, but especially the West. The West has really taken advantage of mixing it up between the run and pass plays.
And very good on the run as well, which is very impressive from both quarterbacks.
All right. We are trying to get the clock started.
Oh,
tricky snap, but is able to pick it up. And incomplete pass intended for Sinai Thomas. But all said and done, that's just going to be an incomplete pass. A lot of drama, and we're going to be back to second and goal.
Yeah, these miscues on the snap, again, he was lucky it actually kind of ended incomplete because it gave him a chance to still not lose any yardage and they still get second down.
But we also like the fact that these quarterbacks have a presence, on a failed play to be able to make something out, at least try and go for the completion.
No, it was a great job of not just falling on it, but being able to pick it up and still look around the field and try to find a guy to throw it to. That's staying poised under pressure right there, and that's what you'd love to see from a quarterback.
All right, a little booth and field clock management still going on. 4:29 left. QB rolling to the right, Vasquez, and a completion. That was intended for Ryan Pupak. And that was incomplete pass. It looked like he had it, but not quite.
Yeah, they've been doing the rollout a lot now, and here we go again with another 10-yard out route, it looks like. And they've been throwing well. It's actually a very good throw. It's just a great play there by Arias right there. Diego Arias being able to undercut the route.
Arias there to disrupt that play. Okay, that's going to bring up third and goal. They had this good momentum.
Yeah.
We're going to see if East can stop them.
Now, they got away from the run here a little bit. And I probably assume that they're going to go for it on fourth down anyways. This could be a down here where they can try to run the ball, see if they could catch him off guard.
Oh. That went through the hands of number 21, Jaden Ortiz.
Intended for Jaden Ortiz, but incomplete. And it will be fourth and goal.
Incomplete, but can I just say that was a great throw by Vasquez right there. Michael Vasquez right there just made a great play of slipping it right between the linebackers, and he just
almost had a hand on it.
Almost had a hand on it right there, but just a great way of fitting it right in between the linebackers.
You know, we are seeing some incomplete passes, but we are seeing some great plays on both sides of the ball
here. There's still some great takeaways even from these
plays
that aren't completed.
Fourth down. And that is touchdown by Aaron Meyer for the West. So the West is the first to put more points on the board in the second half.
Got to hit a little bit of the gritty too. Now again, Meyer has just been having his day so far, and this is just single coverage, and it's just a straight slant. He doesn't even have to do anything, just great throw, first of all, for putting it up the top shelf where he could get it. Great concentration.
But I love the reach of Meyer, the fact that that was really a jump ball, and he was able to pull it in.
Pull it in. Even on a slant route, he was prepared.
And it was caught by number 3, Aaron Meyer, for the touchdown. 2-point conversion coming up.
No fake or anything, just went straight into a slant. Good throw, great catch.
So the kickers aren't getting a lot of use in this game because we're going for yet another 2-point conversion.
This is huge, though. They haven't converted on any yet. Another rollout.
The West has not. Ooh. And that is going to be Vasquez batted down.
Throws the ball, defended by number 34, Ryan Pupak. For the East, it's incomplete.
Pushed intended for Sinai Thomas, but Ryan Pupak got a hand on that and slapped that down. So 4:15 left in this third quarter. Still the West continues to extend their lead 18-8.
This is also just great play by the East team right here. They're starting to catch on to the little flood concept that they're doing when they're rolling out to the right and the left. Covering the out routes. Again, that was a great coverage by Diego Arias there. He had covered the outside route, and then again, the pass disruption there in the goal line.
You know, quite a few of the One Vision alumni have moved into college ranks. Just to name a few, congratulations to Dwayne McDougal upon signing at Northern Arizona. Jeremiah Irby committed to play at Cal. Nico Andrighetto. Congrats going to the University of Michigan, working for Harbaugh. This is just a few of the alumni. It's funny, you see these kids in eighth grade, and it seems like just a blink of the eye, and now they're moving into college, and many of these as D1 schools.
Oh, yeah, and you could see the hints of greatness in each of these games that they play. Another great kick, actually.
Also, shout out to Kaver Baines, who signed his NLI for UC Davis. Number 7, had the ball. Dragged down by number 31 there. Isitolo Tugumusa really on the open field tackle, stopping the run and holding them back. And so they're going to put that down at the 27-yard line.
As well. You don't see that often. But it was a great play by Tugumusa because he actually was about to get the outside edge there and could have taken it for a lot more yards. Not only had a great kick, but also was down there in the field quick enough to make that tackle. Great effort play.
So what's Coach Julian for the East talent in his offense right now? How does he reassert and get that momentum back?
He has to tell them to stay calm. They can't try to get it all back in one play. They just got to play the game, get in rhythm. And again, it comes down to the play calling too. You got to be unpredictable.
Timeout. Hey, by the way, we do want to highlight number 94, Henry Allison, injured right before this game. Also number 76, John Fafita, also for the East injured. You know, and obviously we hate to see any injuries on this, even as part of the practice, but they still remain an important part of this team.
Definitely. And it's still a great experience because they still get the classes and they still get everything else to learn from all these great coaches. But it does suck that they don't have the chance to play in this game.
And we wish all the players who can't play tonight, we're missing. Also shout out to Daniel Henry of the Los Gatos Longhorns. Daniel, unfortunately, quickly recovering from the COVID, and sorry to miss him tonight, but he's also, his teammates told us how much they're going to miss him and wish he were
also
here, and he's still part of their
photos
team.
Photos and updates on the One Vision Instagram @one_vision.
Okay, here are the plays now. We can really catch on guard. Play actions. You see how many people are lined up in the box right now. It's about 8 players.
First and 10 East. Handoff to McLemore, and He gets tackled by number 28, Santino Barragán, and number 20.
That's Vea again right there, looking a lot like Vita Vea the way he's playing tonight. Just putting a lot of pressure in and just always there, always has a presence. Even if he doesn't make the final tackle, he's disrupting these plays.
Just a reminder for our audience, we're seeing a lot of intuition. We're seeing a lot of the defense reading the plays. We're seeing a lot of quick thinking. And all of this is by eighth graders. And so if they're at this level now, we will see them again in high school and many of these kids in college.
Yep. Don't be surprised when we see them in the other All-Star game, the Charlie Riedemeyer game, in their senior years.
All right, second and 11. East has the ball.
They've really disrupted the run here, so let's see if they go away from something else.
Second and 11 for the East.
Pass was intended on that for number 44, Cesar Jimenez. A little short, tried to drive and catch it, but that's going to fall incomplete and bring up third and 11.
I like the play call there. The corners are putting a lot, are giving a lot of room here, as it looks like it's a cover two, but more of a cover four with the way these corners are lining up, and they don't really have the flats right there.
2:59 left in this third quarter, 18-8. West over East, trying to break the winning streak of West is trying to prevail in this contest and break East winning streak.
Let's see. Now it looks like a true, two high safeties right here, and the corners playing up. This is definitely a cover two. You could beat it inside over the middle, or a bit of a hole shot. Here's Miguel. Ooh.
Oh.
Franzino,
number 44 was the intended target. Jimenez. Let's give some credit there also to Jadis Lucky on the defense for helping disrupt that.
Again, these linebackers are doing a great job right now of reading the quarterback's eyes and then adjusting to where they are. He was right there to make the tackle if the receiver had caught it. Would have been right there to make a play. This is interesting. Are they punting here? They are.
All right. So almost for the first time, well, for the first time this half and only for the second time this game, we're going to see them punt on this. Number 44, Jimenez, going to be the punter for the East.
And deep on the return, Isitolo Tugalusu.
Okay.
And that's going to pop up and land about midfield, scooped up by
Kianina.
He's going to walk the tightrope, and he's going to squeeze another eight or nine yards out of that before finally being pushed out by A.J. Rangel.
And Rangel right there with a great tackle there at the end of the play. But this is where, if you're the East right now, you're looking for, you need a big play. You need a turnover right now. You need something to shift that momentum back. And again, they put him in so many third and fourth and long situations. They just got to be able to stop him now. This defense has shown the capability to stop this West team, but right now this West offense is really only hurting themselves by turnovers.
And if you watch the replay, look at the persistence as he does the tightrope to stay in bounds to squeeze out those extra yards.
Great finish on that play.
And to the West's pleasure, they are going to spot the ball on the East 40-yard line. A good field position for getting themselves started to pick up their drive where they left off from the last series.
Yeah.
Handoff there to Diego Hernandez. Diego doesn't get too far with that. He's brought down by Chase Cahoon.
Cahoon again with a great tackle there, great discipline.
And Diego is able to get a couple yards of that, second and eight.
Cahoon filling the gap, squaring his hips, and then being able to make that play.
I'm also impressed with both these teams that they both have made very steady progress down the field.
Yeah.
There have been some big plays,
yeah.
but most of the yardage and most of the scoring has just been with a consistent effort.
Yes, and it's been working with the run game, and it's been working with the short passing game as well. Just slowly
Vasquez
chipping away, driving down the
field. For the West, second and eight.
Second down. Hand off to Hernandez. Big tackle there by 55 by Aziel Jessup-Toina of the Hayward Lancers.
Yeah, great tackle there. He saved a big run right there. He was able to shed off his block and then still be able to get there to stop a very hard runner, by the way. This is a running back who's just been pushing and fighting for extra yards, but he did a great job there. Now here we go again. It's a third and six or about. It's third and kind of medium right here. This is where the plays where the East needs to make stops.
Ball on the East 35-yard line.
Now remember, these rollout passes have been succeeding here on these third down plays. Let's see what they go with here.
Throw by Vasquez, and caught by number 17.
Sanai
Thomas. Pushed out by Matthew Pitt. From the East.
These plays have been automatic so far. They stay disciplined. They continue to go back to these plays, and it works every time. Great throw on the run again. And then Thomas, we've seen it before already. 10-yard out, having enough awareness to know where the out-of-bounds marker is, stay in bounds, even gain a couple yards after.
And yet again, another third-down conversion.
Yep, long third-down conversion. The East needs to be able to stop these. They want to stay in this game.
Hand off to Hernandez again.
Hernandez, nice run off the right side.
And Hernandez. There's flag on the field.
We got flags on the field.
Stefania Alina in the tackle, but there is a personal foul against the defense on this. So
I believe that was actually seven who made the tackle there. That was Matthew Pitt.
Yes. And that's going to...
Interesting to see what this foul call is.
I think it's a personal foul, but we'll see. Personal foul, yes. And that's going to move the West even closer.
Probably marking it half the distance.
Targeting.
That's going to be targeting, yeah.
Yards, we're going to get a first down.
On number 10, huh?
All right, so with that, that's going to bring up first and goal. And counting off those yards, they're going to put the ball on the 5-yard line.
I remember they got, again,
18 seconds left in this third quarter.
The East was putting them in a position, able to kind of have them in third and fourth down here in the goal line. They got to be able to get a goal line stop here. They committed to stopping the run. It looks like they're going to let
this run down.
They're going to let this run down. And with that, we're into the fourth quarter. So we have 12 minutes of football left. The West is leading 18-8. They are on the 7-yard line, looking for 7 more yards to score again. But trust us when we say this football game is not over yet. We've got another 12 minutes of excellent football available.
Yep. And again, the second half adjustments have been great so far for the West. And it's not even so much adjustments. They've just been fixing on the discipline. Not as many penalties. And converting on those thirds down, those rollout passes right now are working to perfection right now. The connection between the quarterbacks, both of them, Mann and Vasquez, to Williams and Thomas, has just been perfect tonight. East right here, this is where you got to get your team motivated. You know, this is the fourth quarter. This is it. It's now or never type situation.
You know, and this also is, we talk about learning. I mean, you learn when you make great plays, but also this is a great learning experience right now for the East. You know, where do they find that grit? Where do they find that extra energy?
Fighting through adversity. Because when you know, one thing you got to know about the game of football is it's never easy. Nothing's ever going to go your way. And this is where the East can learn a lot right here. See how much they can fight through this adversity. Backs against the wall right here.
Football is one of the few popular sports these days that a lot of these kids play that takes absolute teamwork. Everybody's got to do their job for you to be successful.
100%.
All right, first and goal again. Beginning in the fourth quarter.
Roll out. Another 10-yard out.
Vasquez on the roll to the left, throws it.
Yeah.
And
that was intended for number 32, Caden Kelly.
Caden's
from Los Gatos, but falls incomplete.
A great play action play there. Just couldn't finish the connection. He was a great route there. Just
7 yard line.
Just miscommunication.
Second goal at the 7.
Couldn't finish the play.
And just another reminder, these kids have only had less than a month of practices. High school teams really don't start to gel until really they game two or three, and after they've been practicing for a couple
and
months.
And that's after, yeah, that's after a whole summer camp too.
That's right. So
here we go again, a second down. Do they go back to the run here? They haven't ran in the goal line in a while, I feel like.
Oh, little pitch. Reversal number 17, Sinai Thomas. He is going to try and run around the edge, but he's going to be stopped by number 20, Chase Cahoon. And looks like that's going to be a tackle for a loss. Yeah, going to go backwards a little bit.
That play was disruptive from the beginning. That was a great job by the entire East team. Now, I know players like 55 and 33 didn't make the full tackle there, but they did a great job of making Thomas have to keep bouncing outside, keep going into the backfield, and eventually Cahoon was able to get there in the backfield to make the tackle.
Yeah, and it was a tackle for the loss, but I'm just so impressed with how both of these teams are being spontaneous. Mm-hmm. They're reading the defense at any
ready
particular time.
Ready for any trick play.
And staying, quite frankly, improvising where necessary.
Definitely. And they were ready for it. It's impressive that they were ready for a trick play like that.
All right, that's going to bring up third and goal, ball on the 15.
Watch out for a rollout again.
A little bit of a low snap.
Vasquez handles a low snap.
And that was intended.
Oh, my goodness. Kelly almost brings it down.
It's Sinai Thomas, but it was tipped by the defense.
Alatini was there. Pitt was there.
Matthew Pitt was able to get the tip. And yeah, good tip on that. Look at that.
That was number 19 as well, Diego Arias.
Number 19, yes, Diego Arias on that.
What a play, though.
Great disruption. I mean,
great pass disruption. Way to improvise. But I also got to give credit to the quarterback there. Vasquez had a miss, had trouble with the snap, but he was still able to try to make a play out of it.
Well, and he actually got a pretty good throw in.
Got a very good throw in, actually. It had a very good shot. Scoring for a touchdown was just a great play by the defense there.
All right, this is going to bring up fourth and long, ball on the 15. Fourth and goal.
This is a big stop here that they need.
Low snap again. Oh, that ball bounces through the hands of Jesse Deanna. Almost a pick, but enough to turn over the ball on downs. And so good stop there. It looked like the West had a tremendous amount of momentum, but the East picks it up and gets the stop. And now, again, we have a lot of football left.
And it was great pass disruption by the secondary, but Aziel Toina right there, number 55, was able to make a great, able to put pressure on the quarterback just enough to kind of throw the pass off there. And that's how the D-line right there can benefit the offensive line. That's what they need to do. Keep getting pressure on the quarterback so that he doesn't have such a clean pocket and he's not as comfortable.
Okay, ball in the 15, first and 10.
Again, we need some play actions here. Throws on first down. There we go.
And he's just going to throw that away. Avoid the sack.
Gino tosses it out to the flat. Avoids the sack. It'll be second and 10.
I was just about to say, yeah.
But there is a flag down. We're going to guess intentional grounding, but we'll wait for the call.
Let's take a look.
Looks like it's still in the box. So
that was great pressure by the entire D-line there, putting him kind of getting him uncomfortable in that pocket to the point where he felt like he just had to throw it away quickly. And it's got to be given a lot of credit. The West on both sides, defensive line and offensive line, has been doing great on each side.
We're still waiting on the call
here. I think there trying to figure out where he was when he threw it. Intentional grounding, as we anticipated. Loss of down, and so that's going to be a 5-yard penalty, bringing up second and 15 as the ball moves back to the 10-yard line.
That's not a good way to start off the drive right there.
Looks like we're going to wait for them to mark it off.
Again, though, just great pressure by this defense so far. This West defense has been doing a great job, not only disrupting the run game, but the pass game.
Trying to figure out how many yards back to go.
It's so important for a D-line to get pressure on each of those. It affects the entire game.
They're going to make it 10. It's a 10-yard penalty.
Actually, it's a 10-yard penalty. And so we're going to add another 5 onto that.
This is dangerous territory right now, especially with the way this D-line is pushing right now. You want to get a quick pass here. You don't want to take a safety.
And because it's a 10-yard penalty, they're now trying to calculate what is half the distance to the goal.
Nope, maybe not. Back to 10 yards. All right, here we go.
All right, no, we're just gonna go 10 yards, and we're going to spot the ball on the 5-yard line, bringing up second and 20. And, you know, they got their backs against their own end zone.
Yep.
Hand off to number 8.
McLemore with a
McLemore. And McLemore really runs about 16 yards and brings that all the way up to about, we'll see where they spot that, around the 20-yard line.
So he gets more than 10 of it back. It looks like a gain of about 14. It's going to be 3rd and 6.
Yeah, 3rd and 6 now. Gain.
Great block by Nathaniel Vargas right there, the center, nice being run. Able to seal off that nose tackle, kind of putting him away from the play, and it was just a great trap play. Great play call, too. I love the running on second down right there, trying to get some yards back, knowing you pretty much have 4 downs to play with the way these teams have been playing. 3rd and manageable now.
And we have a sack in the back. Number 99 and 90. Patrick Unga and Christopher Unga. These are two twin brothers from the San Jose Hit Squad, and the twins get a twin sack. We're going to give credit to both of them for the sack.
What a play. But also, I got to give a lot of credit there to Michael Langa. He was the first one to put pressure on. He was the one who made him step up in the pocket, help make that play happen.
Looks like his brother, Patrick, was in there as well, causing that
pressure. And so 4th and about 9. We expect them to punt. About 9 minutes left in this game.
No, it looks like we're in punt formation. Here we go.
The West, number 44, Cesar Jimenez, punter. And that's good punt. That's going to bounce just past midfield. Picked up by Kainina.
Oh!
And the ball is fumbled.
We have a fumble.
And it is recovered by White Ball. East recovers.
What a play on the strip there by number 55.
Great special teams work there.
That's what you need right there if you're the East right now. You needed a turnover. You needed something to pick up this team's energy. That's the perfect play right there for the East.
And the East gets a first set of downs.
And the East takes possession of the ball.
My apologies. Antonio Villegas right there with a great play. That's a huge momentum shift right there. That could be a game changer.
Spot that in the 47, so.
Antonio, great play right there. This gives this team life. That's what you wanted for the East. You needed a turnover.
And obviously the West defense is going to try and get the stop and preserve their momentum on both sides.
Yes, and they've been doing a good job of that so far.
1st and 10. And we had a whistle flag. We'll see who moved
right
first.
Typically on the offense.
And that's going to be encroachment.
No, encroachment on defense, offsides. It's going to be 5 yards. It'll be 1st and 5.
And so that's going to bring a 5-yard penalty, 1st and 5.
Or is it false start?
Well, he said encroachment, but they're moving the other way. I'm a little confused.
No, it's a false.
The referee, Mark, He said offsides on the defense.
All right. I think we're getting our official confusion, false starts and encroachment, a little mixed up. Let's see. We will not try and second guess. We will just wait for the... There he goes. Wave that away. It's encroachment.
Okay, so he's correcting the call. It was offsides on the offense.
All right, offsides on the offense.
Just can't hurt yourself with those
That's
calls.
All right. So, correction.
First and 15
now. Penalty against the East.
Just can't worry about that too much. You still have, you're going four downs here anyways.
Toss pass to number eight, McLemore. He's tackled by Santino Berrigan.
What a tackle.
Santino's going to get a tackle for basically no gain.
He's been all over the place. He's able to fight beyond that stiff arm. And McLemore has been a running back who's fought and broken most of the first tackles in this game. Just a great tackle right there to make sure he gains no yards.
8:06 left in this game. West is up by 10.
7 minutes left here. You gotta wonder when they start going to the pass a little more.
Hand off to number eight, McLemore, but number 28, Santino Berrigan, yet another time tackling, and Santino's going to tackle them, just maybe a yard gain on that. Still going to be third and 12 as they spot the ball in the 46.
Yeah, this kid's entering the zone right now with the way he's playing. He's just, he's in a whole nother zone right now. He's seeing things differently. He's moving much quicker. The game feels like it's slowing down for him. You could definitely tell.
What's a great thing to see about kids this age is when the light bulb gets on,
yep,
and they realize what they need to do to be successful, what they need to win. And, you know, going back to the whole idea behind One Vision is they can see it and they can touch it. Well, here we're seeing a player that can see it and can touch it,
yep,
and is performing at that level.
Yep.
Third down. Handoff number eight, runs up the middle.
McLemore
gets out. Gets out to about midfield. He was tackled by Isaiah Pinnell, number six, and number 28. Berrigan. But that's going to still leave fourth and three. And, you know, you're down 10 points, 627, little past midfield. I'm going to guess they're going to go for it just on what they've done so far.
You have to go for it here. What I do like, though, on that last play is going for a run. Obviously, they knew that they had another down to play with, but that run was a little unpredictable on third down. That's why it worked so well. But now here you go. You have fourth and short. You have corners playing up. This could be a chance here to take a shot if you want to.
Hand off number eight, running up the middle. Keep on running.
Uh-oh.
All the way for McLemore. Tackled by 28 and 9, Berrigan and Powell. But there's a flag on the field.
The flags were down the field.
Denham Powell, part of the tackle, but we'll see what that flag is for.
We'll wait for the referee call.
Personal foul.
Personal foul.
Face mask
on the defense.
Against the defense, so ouch. That's going to be another 15 yards tacked on after the run. Got to do some math here based on where they spotted it.
Can I just say that was a great combo block there by 55 and 56, Azeel Towina and Nathaniel Benuelos. They were able to seal off the nose tackle right there and just create a big lane. It was a great combo block right there.
So the ball ends up on the 10, first and goal.
Helped break off that big
one. Yeah, and 10-point lead. East looking to reduce that lead very quickly.
Here we go again.
Inside handoff there, almost delayed, almost like a draw.
Fullback dive, number nine, Gonzalez.
Angelos
Gonzalez from Union City Colts.
About one. It'll be second and goal from the nine.
And it's going to bring up second and goal.
I like the idea of the trap play there. That's just a great play by Patrick Unger right there. Just being ready for that, staying on the inside, having an inside release, and just once he saw the run get right by me, he was able to shed the block and make that tackle. Now, remember, you have A.J. Rangel Jr. here. This is a guy who can be a bit of a mismatch in man coverage.
Handoff.
Oh,
to McLemore. McLemore makes his way and touched him.
Oh, my
McLemore
God.
For the East.
Ikaya McLemore.
One more.
McLemore just bulldozed his way through.
What a run. Just hard fought, keeping the legs going. Very Marshawn
Lynch. Two or three different tackles there.
That's just what we've been seeing from McLemore all day, though. He's been running the ball with great energy and great power. Now, this is a huge two-point conversion.
And I'll say, on that last play, there's something that we're not seeing from McLemore. We're not seeing somebody getting tired. As many times, as many points as McLemore's made, we're seeing this spurt of energy continuing well into the fourth quarter with 4:41 left in the game.
And that's very dangerous when you have it later in the game when the defense gets tired and you still have a running back who's running.
Flag on the field, false start. All right, so that's going to go back 5 yards. So that's going to be first and goal with the ball about on the 9-yard line.
It's dangerous when you can have a workhorse like McLemore, though. He's able to keep going at the same speed while everyone else is just getting more tired. This is where a running back like McLemore can take over the game.
Well, one thing they will all learn about in high school is conditioning, especially this upcoming summer.
Yes.
Two-a-days.
But it isn't just conditioning as well. It's sometimes just bringing in, entering that second gear, bringing in that extra momentum, energy, pulling it out from, you know, wherever. You know, you gotta find it and you gotta dig deep right there and you gotta find that inner strength. And that's what McLemore is doing right now here at the end of the game. So now this is a long two-point conversion. I almost wonder if they're gonna try to pass here. And
more laundry on the field, and we have a false start. So we're going to go back again. We're still on that two-point conversion, and it's a really long two-point conversion. I don't think they're going to take the option of trying and doing the PAT. They're going to stick with the two-point conversion.
Yeah. Well, sticking to your guns, I respect that. This just makes it very hard to convert now.
Yeah, but we've seen that both with the longer two-point conversions. We've seen the third down and fourth down, and third and long, fourth and long.
Exactly.
And so.
But the way this game's been going, nothing's out of question. Here we go.
Pass. And that, is picked by 15 defense, and again in this league, you can't run back to two-point conversion. So with that, we have a 4:41 left in this game. West leads the East 18-14. See him jump up for that and just grab it.
Yeah. What great elevation there by Jadis Lucky. It was great positioning there. He was there to be ready for when the ball fell short. It's all about positioning. Okay, now this is the possession right here. This changes the game. You need a stop here for the East, and you've had stopped them now for the most of the fourth quarter. You had that big turnover, and you had that big goal line stop now. This is a game again. It's only 4 points here.
So we have
DC
Tuagamusu is deep as well as 20.
This could be a very exciting last
Joseph Patterson. Joseph Patterson from South Valley Grizzlies. Jimenez, kicker for the East.
They tried a couple short kicks before.
Number two has the ball. Gaina.
That was a great
nice
pick up there. That, he picked that up with no worry at all.
He was tackled by Nathaniel Vargas from the South Valley Grizzlies.
These kicks are hard to get. He was able to pick up that ground ball with ease and then still get some yards to go.
A.J. Rungo also helping out with that.
Very good.
You know, one thing I really like about this game, too, is that we're seeing a lot of different players getting into the game.
Yes.
We're not talking about first string or second string. Many of these players are getting some reps in. And they're all outstanding players and
definitely
seeing outstanding performance.
Both offensively and defensively. A big one to mention, too, could be like in the West, where we had Mann doing a great job at quarterback in the first half. And now we have Vasquez doing just
hand off to Hernandez, number 8. Hernandez gets a little bit up the left-hand side. He gets tackled.
Great stop there on the run.
Gets a couple yards. It was second and 8.
Jimenez.
Cesar Jimenez.
And Cahoon on the stop there.
So it was only a gain of 2.
Gain of 2 yards, second and 8.
Holton Hyder was also there on the play.
You know, the West has made it into the East territory now, so it's on the 48.
Yeah. Just need to stop him here on this possession.
3:52 left.
I'm going to stick with
handoff number 8. Flag comes down.
Flag.
And
nice run by
Hernandez.
But we have flags.
Makes about 5, tackled by Alatini and Kupak, but we will see
a holding.
Assisted on that tackle. But with the flag in the offensive backfield,
that's a huge holding.
Yeah, that's going to be holding. Ouch.
Again, it's just some of these flags are hitting the West now at the worst possible time. That was a good run that they got there, and it's just now they have to backtrack. But they have been running time off the clock now. They got about a minute off this clock. If they could get a minute more or two, it can make this final drive that the East would have to make very difficult.
Yeah, but with only a 4-point lead, you surely don't want to rest.
Definitely.
That's going to make it second and 22.
You would much rather get the first down and end it right now.
All right, walking the ball backwards, second and 22 because of the spot foul.
You got to get pressure on this quarterback right here. The East has done a good job with the run. Let's see if they can get some pass pressure now.
Caught by Aaron Meyer. But he gets pushed out by Ryan Kupak. And so that's going to be good for about 6 yards.
Great push out. I mean, great run there by Meyer on the little one route. And what Kupak did a great job of is pushing him out of bounds, actually stopping the clock.
Third and 17. I think this is, at least for the West, maybe one of the more critical conversions
yes.
of the entire game.
Big time. And they've been converting big time on these third and fourth and longs. So obviously the East needs to be ready for the pass here. But the biggest thing here that the West, what you don't want to do is have an incomplete pass.
They can convert to the first down, keep the clock running, and obviously have a chance to score. Otherwise, they're going to have a very tough decision.
This could be a big decision right here.
Refs
call.
Refs
call.
Refs call is telling us to run it.
The pressure.
Oh. Attended by Sinai Thomas, but Diego Arias really disrupted that, and that ball is going to fall then to the ground.
Ball's incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, almost had it. And so that's
Tony Villegas
right there. Again, fourth and 17.
Again, it all comes down to the D-line, and Antonio Villegas right there with great play, putting pressure there on the defense, on the quarterback, getting him off his base so that he can make a throw that fell short. Again, it all comes down to the D-line. We're making pressure right there, and it looks like, am I mistaken here, or are they going for it?
It looks like they're going for it. I'm surprised. Yeah, I would have thought they would have punted and then depended on their defense, but
wow,
again, they're not even at midfield, so up. And we have a timeout. Timeout taken by.
Timeout.
It's going to look like, yeah, timeout taken by the West. This is their first timeout of the half, so.
They got to think this through, because if they're going to go for it here, they need a big play. They've converted a lot of fourth and longs, but this would have to be.
I don't know. This feels a little bit.
This would have to be
too much of a gamble for me.
Big time, especially because you're giving the ball in your own territory right now.
But then again, you and I are sitting up here in the booth.
They're down there on the field.
And that's right. And so
We'll see what they do, though. In the end, we have to make mention, though, Meyer and Thomas have just been having a great day so far. So let's see if they try to go to one of them. If they find whichever one's in single coverage, that might be the one that they target. Two high safeties. It looks like it's going to be a cover four look. Only five in the
okay,
box.
Okay, fourth down, 2:46 left.
Preparing for the pass. Oh, it's a punt.
All right.
And oh, flat.
And huge punt, but a whistle on that, and we will see. Did they call a timeout? I don't see a penalty flag down.
It's like oh, it's right there. What is it on?
I see a false start signal.
It's a big false start here because this really just backs him up a little more. And it was actually a good punt there. He was able to kind of get it.
All right, so false start. They're going to move back five. I guess they were asking whether the East wanted to decline, but no, they're actually going to. All right, so they are going to punt.
Yeah, it looks like it's another pooch punt. And it doesn't.
And much. And caught by number 10, Elatini. He moves up along the sideline.
Oh, my.
Keeps
oh, my
on
God.
Going, keeps on going.
Are you kidding me?
Heading all the way back down. Touchdown.
Are you kidding me?
On the return for the East with 2:28 left in the game. Now, note, there is a flag down.
There is a flag. Where? The far end, or where is it at?
We thought we saw a flag. Maybe they picked that up. Correction. No flag down. That touchdown is good.
Oh my God. This game has just been flipped on its head. We have to give a lot of credit here to the special teams of the East so far. A punt return and also forcing a fumble on the last punt. This was just a great return by number 10 right here, Stefani.
And we've got 2:28 left and a lot of football left. We are not done here.
Again, just great blocking, and then he was able to just break that one tackle and then take it upfield. They had a convoy of blockers. It just set up so perfectly. And again, that false start penalty now is so huge.
Now, it's interesting. They're going to go for the two-point conversion. I guess they obviously want to try that, but you'd wonder whether they just want to try and get the PAT and maybe try and get up by one field goal.
Well, because the interesting thing is now is if you don't convert this, if the West, say, drives down the field, we might see the first field goal of the game.
That's right. That's right.
Which now, would lead to an interesting situation.
You know, the wonderful thing about this game is that even at this level, it's strategy, strategy, strategy.
Yes, definitely. Wow, just what a turn of events. The East mounting back.
All right.
Let's see what they do here.
Handoff number 8. And he looks
oh
like
my
he's
God.
Gets stopped.
Oh, he's in.
Oh, no, correction. 2-point conversion. I thought he was stopped from my vantage point. And
you can't stop him.
That.
You can only hope to contain him. This man has been a monster all day in fighting for yards after contact, and he did it in one of the biggest plays of the game there, giving it a 4-point game. Now they need a touchdown to win the game.
We were questioning the wisdom of going for the 2-point conversion, and now it looks like a wise decision because flipping it, now the East is up by 4 over the West.
Wow.
The West had enjoyed a lead almost the entire game, and now they've got 2:28 to make their way down the field.
This comeback all happening with 11 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
Now, keep in mind, the West still has 2 timeouts left.
Yes,
and 2 timeouts and 2:28 is a lot of time.
And remember, the West has been throwing the ball very well, and the only thing that has really stopped them have been penalties. This is a very, they can make this drive. They just have to make sure they stop themselves from the penalties. discipline is huge. If they can stop that, then we can have a very, we have a game-winning job possibly on our hands here.
So we are going to have Cesar Jimenez kicking. We got EC Tugumusu.
Kaimani had a good return last time as it was kicked directly to him. Let's see where he tries to kick him now.
Up for the return in the backfield.
I wouldn't want to target him again. I try to kick it a little more to the left. There we go.
Good kick picked up by Patterson. Patterson runs up the right-hand side, makes his way out. Finally, and he cuts back, jukes him. We thought he's going to be run out. Great.
That
great play. Finally stopped by Malachi Ferguson.
Oh, he definitely didn't make it interesting, though, to say the least. My. Okay, I'm loving the way these players are just running hard after the
play. That's right, and then he's not giving up. You know, he cuts back and then cuts in and jukes him.
Not going down
as much as he can possibly get.
Exactly. All those yards are huge. Now, here we are. 2:17 left. It's going to be number 5 at quarterback here. Let's see what Michael Vasquez can do. This is it. This is a big drive here for this entire offense. This is a big experience. Not only is it in a big game, but now this is a game-winning drive. It looks like what's happening here.
You know, the kids came here tonight to, in part, get the high school football experience. This is tremendous high school football experience for these kids. This is their ability to perform under this situation in this game shows that they're all going to be very successful.
Definitely, definitely.
We have both coaching staffs in the middle of the field with the refs.
Interesting to see how this is all going down.
And they're obviously discussing something.
I just want to remind the coaching staff, this is just an all-star game.
Yeah, just a reminder that the coaches are rooting for their teams. Let's get these kids
playing. While you do hate to see these disputes, it's also cool to see the amount of passion that these coaches are putting
That's true.
In the game as well. Because it obviously means that they put a lot of time into this game and setting it all up. You hate to see this come out, but... biggest thing for the players here, just you got to have your head coaches here. Stay up to the side. Get your players focused here. This is a big drive for both teams here.
So we are still trying to get ourselves settled here. You know, it's interesting. I'm looking right in front of me in terms of the East, and we have all the kids there sort of taking a knee. Working together as a team, really understanding the spirit of what it means to be a team, to celebrate both their successes and the challenges they have. And we're also seeing a lot of good patience here from a lot of the players on the West here. And so, you know, these kids are taking the lessons of what it means to be a good sportsman and showing us as adults that they're a good sportsman.
I love the maturity that these players are showing right now at such a young age. Let's see which side is motivated here. It looks like both coaches are trying to fire up their team a little bit.
I think they will have succeeded. I think we got a lot of excitement. 2:17 left in this game.
Again, so now if you're the East, watch out for those rollout passes, not just the rollouts, but the out routes that come with it. They've been working so good.
1st and 10, ball on the 35. Here
we go. Go. Simple drop back.
Oh,
oh my.
Tended. 32. Defended by number 10. Now, Latini almost picked by Alatini.
Alatini right now is making a strong case for MVP.
Oh,
with the
wow.
He's finishing off this game. What a great effort.
Frankly, that was a great effort by both of those players lunging at the ball.
Oh, my. Alatini, though, with a great read there on the quarterback's eyes, which you want from a safety, and then making a break on the ball. Again, we talked about guys who are entering the zone in a bit of rhythm right now. Alatini looks to be in that zone.
with that incomplete pass. Second and 10.
Looks like we have a timeout on the field.
And we're going to do a timeout right here.
Is this from the east or the west?
I'm guessing
the east would use their timeouts.
That's right, but we shall see. This would be the first timeout for the east in this half.
I think it would be a smart use of it too. Give your players a chance to cool down, calm down, relax. And let's get focused for this next play here. And it gives the coaches a chance to tell them what to expect next. Now, this is a drop back play on the first play.
You're the coaching staff. You're trying to balance both the emotion and the energy, but also with playing smart. How are these coaches finding that balance?
Well, obviously, you know, you keep up the energy when you're talking, but it's the talking points that are huge. Obviously, it's the energy that you bring to the huddle is very important. That keeps the energy up, but it's the talking points that are important. Telling them what to look for, telling the defense to stay disciplined. That helps keep them very focused.
We're going to. All right.
Here we go, another rollout.
Long throw intended. 32. And, he jumped out and landed out of bounds. Great throw, a great catch, just a little bit off.
A great throw. I think that's a magnificent throw for an eighth grader to make that rolling to his right. This is a corner route. This isn't an out route. And he puts it quite literally in the perfect spot. Now, where this has to be given credit to, though, is Pitt for pushing him out. And also a great catch by the receiver. Can we just mention that, too?
And so we are seeing some of the kids here.
If you cannot be professional, you will be asked to leave.
A lot of enthusiasm here right now. A lot of people all excited about this. And so we've got third down and 10, 2:09 left.
They can definitely get a big play, though, with the arm that this kid has. Interesting.
Oh, drop snap, and we get a sack in the back by Vasquez.
And Vasquez being very hard to take down again. That actually
pulled. Well, they finally whistled him dead before he was down. All right, that's going to be a loss of about 3, but it's going to be about 4th and 15. Ooh, 1:49 left.
Again. With the arm that this kid has and the way these receivers are playing, 4th and 15 is not impossible.
And just a reminder that the West only has one timeout left.
Yes. And now the clock is running. It's 1:35 now. That sack did take a lot of time off the clock. Who is that? Is that Thomas over on the far end? That's one of the big time receivers to look for. Oh. Double pass.
Double pass. Oh, and that's going to fall short. Defended by Alatini, and with that, the East takes over.
Oh, I love the creativity with that. Can we talk about the pressure, though, put on?
And we were told that we would see a huge variety of plays and plays you would not necessarily expect to see from a bunch of eighth graders. Yeah. And I think that last play just shows that.
Just showed it. I got to say, Colton Hyder with a great job, even after the first pitch, staying on the side of the quarterback, being ready for that pass back, and then putting pressure on the quarterback to make that throw fall short.
1:18 left in this game. I have to do our math here to see if they're going to be able to just take a knee. It looks like they're in the victory. In the victory formation, just run out the clock, and they take a knee as the clock.
And it's, so this is. Yeah.
Clock is running down. They take their last time out for the West.
Their last time out, though. So it looks like it's going to be setting up for another East victory again. This is the 5th time in the row, if I am correct. Wow.
Great game by these kids on both sides of the ball.
What a finish to this game, though. Just the special teams being the difference maker. Who would have thought? Especially in a game where we didn't see too much special teams anyways, with not many punts. And then the last two punts of the game end up being the two biggest plays of the game. Fumble forced on that other punt, and then a punt return for a touchdown for the go-ahead lead.
And we have the victory formation once again. And that's going to run out the clock.
Again, we talked about how the East had to fight through adversity in those last, and once that fourth quarter hit, we talked about this is, shows a lot about the East here. If they can fight through this adversity, keep their heads high, and just keep fighting through this game and wait for that breakthrough, and they did.
So we're a little confused. We thought they were out of timeouts. We wouldn't think that the East would call the timeout.
Okay, well,
maybe
I spoke a little too soon here.
I thought we counted up the timeouts, right? Maybe not. Maybe the West had one more timeout. Either way, the clock has stopped.
Well, it seems like everyone else is just
third down.
But it looks like it is a ton. Of, no, another
I think they're going to get one more shot at the ball. Knee down. Okay, now the clock is running, but it is fourth down.
That's the thing, though.
Less than a minute.
It's not game over yet, is it? The clock can't run down a whole minute with the play clock.
They run down to 20, do the play, and then it'll be fourth down, and obviously stop the clock between. East over West, and we have a flag out. Delay of game, which is not surprising.
Okay, yeah, so they ran the clock. 35 seconds left.
And obviously, because they're taking the victory formation, they're not terribly concerned about the five-yard delay of game penalty.
But this is interesting.
Fourth down.
Now. Like, because it's fourth down, fourth and very long. First of all, you don't want to have a turnover, but you also can't run too much clock off unless you actually get a first down. So it's going to be interesting to see what they do here. I would play conservative, though. I wouldn't take the risk of there being a turnover. 18 at quarterback.
Franzino is quarterback.
Yeah.
Dive to number eight. Macklemore.
Still hard to take down.
Runs through, and with that, I don't think he got a tackle by 31. EC Togamusu, and so we have a turnover and downs with 29 seconds left. I have to wonder, was that a tactical mistake for the East? Because now 29 seconds, you know, that's probably good for a couple plays. And
obviously, there was a bit of confusion when they didn't even know that the other team had two timeouts left. It was very weird how that situation played out. I do like how they ran that last play, though, just keeping it conservative with the run play. Don't want to risk a turnover or anything and still run as much time off the clock as you can. But we've seen these receivers succeed a little bit here. Are we going to get a bit of a Minneapolis miracle? Possibly, what could we call this, the Silver Creek miracle?
You wonder if they're going to do a short pass the outside to just
get some yardage. Could be. They're given so much space. A wide receiver screen right now would work beautifully. Uh-oh, that's not the one.
And he is number three, got the ball.
You got to hurry
Aaron up. Meyer, but he got tackled by Chase Cahoon. Chase was all over that.
Cahoon again.
16 seconds left.
You got to get ready to run a play here. The defense is a little miscommunicated, too.
10 seconds left. Possibly the last play of the game.
Pressure at the end of the game.
And
oh
we get a
God.
Sack at the
what
end of the
play.
Game. And with that, sacked by 66 to end the game. So the fifth annual
great game by both sides.
One Vizion 8th grade All-Star game
great
ends
game, kids. Let's keep the sportsmanship.
22-18.
Awesome.
East continues its winning streak over the West.
Wow. What a finish to this one.
Congratulations
this
to the
this
East.
Just took a turn the there in the it just and got spun on its head there in the final 10 minutes
Daniel
of this game.
Cruz,
what
Brooks,
a finish.
Eric Wood, Ellen Chapman, Darnell
again, a lot of credit to both teams here. They both played a great game. Again, this is just an all-star game. It's an opportunity for these players to showcase their talent and play with more elite talent. Also, just the experience of playing in this game, learning from these coaches, and playing with these teammates is just an awesome experience. But it's amazing what we saw from many of these players. The toughness.
While we have a chance, we'd like to thank One Vision Sports for allowing us to come out and watch the game tonight. It's a great organization. helping develop these kids into great athletes and people. And while this is the end of the game, be certain that this is not the last time we'll see these kids. Watch for them leading high school teams, some college, some even NFL, and many others. If we don't see them there, we know we're going to see them becoming leaders in their communities. We wish them continued success. Great kids.
Definitely.
We're going to do a recap here.
Wow, what a finish, though. This is such a great game, and I love seeing these guys huddle around, showing a lot of sportsmanship. Here we go with the highlight plays. First of all, the great read.
The pick in the first quarter, really going out early in the game, coming back, put the West on the board.
Yeah. Great read there. Great return back as well. Set the tone early on.
You see, he was really anticipating that.
But then this.
And then that two-point conversion. And so we had some good two-point conversions, some failed. That was a failed two-point conversion.
Again, those are actually turned out to be very big here at the end of the game. It was a two-point conversion that made the difference, that pick being
and
one of them.
They came back then.
And this run was a big one. This throw here, too, this throw and catch. What a catch in traffic.
Right in there.
Heavily contested. Oh, and then here, this is the big momentum-shifting play right here.
Picked up.
Antonio Villegas right here. This was the game-changing play. The strip right on the ball. Perfect tackle. Momentum shift.
And that shift was enough to actually help them
mount back and win it. Oh, what a run here, too.
With the game. And we have a touchdown.
McLemore, great run. But that's not all that we'll see. Again, another great play here defensively to stop this two-point conversion.
And that's not a pick. It's just a end of the two-point conversion. But that's, you know, that makes the difference.
Makes the difference. But then here it is. This is the play of the game right here. Just an unexpected return here.
All the way in.
19 with
all the way out from the 33-yard line.
Then he just gets an entourage, and he's gone.
67-yard return.
Unreal.
And that puts him up.
That is just, wow. And teams don't practice for those situations. That's just amazing right there that they were ready for that.
And then that's good for that two-point conversion, pushing him through enough so they needed to get that. And so with that, we have the final again, 22-18, East over West for the One Vision 8th grade All-Star game. We want to give credit to our producer, Luis Costa, engineer in charge, and many other things, Justin Cowgill. Replay, Caitlin did a great job. Caitlin Zizzo. This is your announcer, Mark Diamond.
I'm Alejandro Flores.
Spotter, Sean Diamond. Camera operators and production assistants, Holly Garcia, Donna Wallach, Art Maurice, Jorge Gomez, and Steve Macias. Yeah. Thank you for the whole CreaTV team. Thank you for One Vision Sports. And we wish you and all these kids success in their future endeavors.
Definitely. Can't wait to hear from them more.
Good night.